From teams down south, Essex and now Shenandoah.
Red Oak. Yeah, it was Essex last night. It's a doubleheader tonight, Red Oak and Shenandoah. Traditional rivalry game. So looking for some good basketball here.
Is tonight kind of as a conference game? I think it does.
I think it does. This is potentially, and we'll get into it in a little bit, Matt, but this is potentially a historic night, potentially.
Yeah, you're jumping ahead, but you're right. Yeah. At the boys' game, we could have some significant Red Oak sports history tonight as Max DeVries needs 12 points to become the all-time scoring leader in school history. And, you know, really, that's kind of like the almost like in baseball terms, that's like the home run record. You know, it has that sort of significance of all the records in basketball. That's the big one. And it's really, you know, from a rail perspective, that goes back decades. And, of course, the game has changed. A lot of the guys in the old era didn't have the three-point line and all that stuff. But it's a remarkable achievement, and he has an opportunity tonight to etch his name in the history of Red Oak.
So we'll get into that, Matt. We don't want to jump too far ahead, but that's on – I mean, it's certainly within striking distance tonight. So, but let's talk about varsity girls play, Matt. We have – Red Oak and Shenandoah. Red Oak coming off of a win last night over the Essex Trojans. A much different Red Oak team this year than what we've seen in the past still.
Yeah, 53 points on the board last night. You know, that's the highest offensive output by a Tiger girls basketball team. I think it's 2021 or something. So, you know, positive trend there for the Tigers. But they're going to be, of course, facing their rival tonight, the Shenandoah Phillies in town. The Phillies are 1-3. On the year, they have had a loss to Councilist AL, Underwood and Harlan, and they beaten Southwest Valley. So 1-3 start for the Phillies this year. I looked at last year comparatively this year. The Phillies had the exact same setup of games this year as they did last year, and they are exact same place as they were coming in the Red Oak game last year, 1-3. And, of course, they beat Red Oak last year. Head coach is John Weinrich, assistant coach Kiero Ratliff. But a really good Phillies team. We can talk about them now, or we can hold on what you want to do.
What we're going to do, Matt, before we get into that, let's take a break. And I would ask you to make note of our sponsors as we move along through the evening, both here and online. By the way, we're streaming too, by the way.
Wow.
If you would happen to want to watch the game over on our YouTube channel, you can hop over there and watch if you wish, or you can listen here, whichever works best for you. We say thanks for doing it.
One play can change momentum in a game, and one deductible is a game changer when it comes to your insurance. That's why you should see me, Richard Fisher, your Farm Bureau agent in Red Oak. I can help bring your car and home together in a single policy. So if life sends you a blitz in the form of a storm or fire, you'll pay just one deductible for everything that's covered. Come see how we can help protect what matters most. That's Richard Fisher down at Farm Bureau Financial Services across from the post office here in Red Oak.
Farm Bureau Property and Casualty Insurance Company, Western Agricultural Insurance Company.
Hawkeye Ford in Red Oak is all new and better than ever. I'm Mike Utz, the new general sales manager. We boosted our inventory and expanded our dedicated sales and service teams while retaining the familiar faces you trust. Buying, selling, or trading, we've got you covered. Experience the fresh selection of cars and top-notch service at Hawkeye Ford in Red Oak. Discover more at HawkeyeFord.com.
I'm Aaron West along with Matt Davis and Melanie West with us as well. Okay, Matt, Looking at these two teams, what are you expecting here? What do you see at these two? We're looking at these two teams.
Well, obviously two rivals, and you know they're really going to get after it here. They can make or break your season by beating your rival. But the Phillies are in town tonight, and Red Oak head coach John Weinrich, 1-3 on the year. Last year they were 10-12. Shenandoah has won the last six games in this series against Red Oak. The last Red Oak win was way back in January 2019. So the Phillies have kind of owned it here over the last 3 or 4 years. Phillies are led by junior Lene Green, 14 points per game, 13 rebounds per game. She shoots 62% from the free throw line. She's fourth in the Hawkeye 10 in scoring early here in the season. Other leaders for the Phillies include senior Jenna Burdorf, 6 points per game, eight rebounds per game. And then senior Caroline Rogers, 6 points per game. She's shooting 29% from three. We'll have other contributors, but those kind of the main frontline contributors. Phillies average 41 points per game. They give up 49 points per game. They're shooting 26% from the field, 17% from the three line, and 55% from the free throw. But here's a stat, Aaron, that just jumps off the board at you. They're averaging 41 rebounds a game. Of that, 15 of those are offensive games. That's number one in the Hawkeye 10. They're the number one rebounding team and the number one offensive rebounding team in the Hawk 10. 19 turnovers per game, 8 fouls per game. And they're also move and pass the ball well as their second assist. So this is a team that gets after it. Lene Green, of course, is a big part of that. She is just incredible. We've seen her have some tremendous rebounding games against the Tigers. She controls that glass, both offensive, defensively. That'll be a big challenge for the Tigers tonight to try to limit that. This is where those box outs and trying to get good body position are going to be important for the Tigers if they're going to try to limit Lene Green from dominating the boards. For the Red Oak Tigers, 2-3 on the year, coming off a big win against Essex last night, 53-38. Tigers have beaten East Mills and Essex. They've lost to Lenox, Lewis Central, and Clarinda. They're led by senior Olivia Boswell, 11 points per game, shooting 54% from the three line. That's second in the Hawkeye 10. Senior Merced Ramirez, 4 points per game, 9 rebounds per game. Merced is fifth in the Hawk 10 rebound, and we've seen her and how important that is to help down low as she comes down from her guard position to help on the rebounds. Tigers are averaging 34 points offensively. And again, if you follow Tigers basketball program, that doesn't seem like a lot, but that is a remarkable improvement so far for 4 games over last year. They give up 54 points defensively. And here's the stat of the night for the Tigers. Tigers shoot 22% from the field. Aaron, they're shooting better from the three. They're 24% from the three. They're 20 of 82 from the three. They're shooting better from the three line than they are from the field. If I'm a player, I'm saying, Coach, I'm going to let it fly every time.
Take the three.
Tigers are shooting 33% from the free throw line, so they need to get that free throw percentage up. They're averaging 28 rebounds per game, 21 turnovers per game. So the Tigers are second in the Hawkeye 10 after 4 games and made three-pointers, second in Hawkeye 10 in three-point attempts. They're lighting up line, they're shooting from three. And when they go in, it's a beautiful thing. When they don't, it's not. So kind of an analysis there, I think, for the Shenandoah team. I'm sure each team scouts each other and looks at these same things we do, so they're conscious of what the other team is doing and not doing, and you'll probably see the Phillies really be conscientious of trying to guard Olivia out there on that three-point line tonight.
All right, so about 7 minutes away from the lineups being announced here in Red Oak this evening. Hop in your car if you're anywhere in the area. Come on down and watch basketball. You can still get 2 games in. Varsity girls, varsity boys.
Two for the price of one.
2 games in this evening. Hey, in junior varsity play just prior to this, it was Red Oak in 2 quarters of play. Red Oak over Shenandoah, 19-15 in 2 quarters of play.
I didn't see the JV game over, but I know Red Oak was winning pretty handily in the fourth quarter in that one as well.
All right. Take a break and we'll be back after this.
Across Nebraska and southwest Iowa, too many people are living with pain, but they avoid seeking orthopedic care. If only they'd ask themselves one question: what's the best that could happen? At Ortho Nebraska, we make care as easy and comfortable as possible. You can be seen today without a referral, and the majority of patients don't require surgery. Whatever your pain, we offer the most accessible and personalized care to get you back to living your best life. Ortho Nebraska. Click, call, text, or walk in.
here in Red Oak this evening. And varsity girls play upcoming in just a few minutes. Shenandoah and Red Oak. The Phillies and the Tigers here in varsity girls play upcoming.
The maroon versus the orange and black.
Okay, Matt.
Or is it maroon or is it burgundy?
It's maroon.
Maroon, yeah. Keys are the game for Shenandoah tonight. They want to get Red Oak in that press. They're going to press Red Oak, turn them over. That's the recipe the Tigers are going to see. We saw a little bit of that the other night, and I think that's going to come tonight from the Phillies. So they're going to do that. Offensive rebounding, hit those glasses. Hit that glass, get your second, third chance opportunities. Lene Green, she is a tremendous player, and she's going to be a hard handle for the Tigers to control down there tonight. And a fast start. Phillies want to get out on top, break the game open early, and get going. Keys for Red Oak, play at their pace. Red Oak doesn't really want to get an up-and-down game. It's going to be difficult if Shenandoah is pressing, which I think they will. Defensive rebounding, obviously, it's just the opposite. Tigers will somehow have to try to slow down the Phillies on the offensive glass. Good positioning, try to get good rebounding positioning and limit those shot opportunities and let it fly, Aaron. Let it fly. We'll see what the Phillies open up with. If they open up in a zone, you can see some three-point shots, but I think the Phillies might go man here. Try to run the Tigers off that three-point line, a full-court press and man-to-man. We'll see what Coach Weinrich has in store tonight for his game plan against the Tigers.
Tigers come in, like I mentioned earlier, Matt, off of a game last night, pick up a victory, so they have a little momentum. But does that play into – I know Coach Johnson said we'll play as many as we can get.
Yeah, I think still early enough in the season that there's not really a fatigue. In fact, I think it kind of is a good thing to get a game in. I mean, if they hadn't had a game last night, they're coming off a 4 or 5 day break, and it's hard to get back. No, but they were just here last night, so I think that's a good thing for Red Oak in that regard. But like I say, you get down in the middle of January where you've had game after game, week after week, it could add up. But right now, I think it's not really a detriment or a help. It's just kind of a flow of the season right now.
Okay. Reserves for the Shenandoah Phillies here in the game this evening. Abigail Dumler is a sophomore for the Phillies. Sarah Pickens is freshman at 5'3". You have Callie Bebout, a sophomore, 5'4". And Alexis Shabam is a junior.
Hey, I like those names, Bebop and Shabam. Bebout. I like those names.
Bebout and Shabam.
Good names.
Kylie Fouch, a junior, 5'4". Nora Martin is a sophomore. Abigail Martin is a senior, 5'7". Those are your reserves for the Shenandoah Phillies. Starters include Chloe Denton, a junior, 5'4". Caroline Rogers, a senior, 5'7". Cassidy Stevens, a senior, 5'6". Jenna Burdorf is a senior, 5'10". And Lene Green is a junior, 6'1". Those are your starters for the Phillies.
What was that Philly player? It was just a dynamo last year. Was stealing. Was that Martin? I was thinking maybe. I can't remember who it was, but we'll probably recognize when he was there. But they had a guard, I thought, last year that was just all over the court with steals and defense and layups. And
we'll see here, Matt, when we get going. Reserves for the Red Oak Tigers, Natalie Johnson, a freshman, 5'8". Haley Rydberg is a senior, 5'10". Mariel Ramirez, a freshman, 5'7". Casey Kells, a senior, 5'4". Caden Wingfield, a senior, 5'3". Grace Wingfield, a senior, 5'3". Ella Johnson is a junior, 5'6". Those are your reserves. Starters for the Tigers in tonight's ballgame, Jaden Lindsay, a senior, 5'8". Olivia Boswell, senior, 5'6". Merced Ramirez is a senior, 5'9". Ellison Johnson, a sophomore, 5'6". And Emily Siebenecker is a sophomore, 5'6". Those are your starters for the Red Oak Tigers.
Tigers playing their new intro. They play a hype video on their big digital scoreboard. Yeah. Dim the lights. Atmosphere, Aaron.
Got the hat. Got
atmosphere. They still need to do a – we had a spotlight when we were
– Did
we
you played, really?
Oh, yeah. It would be complete. They had a big spotlight in the corner, and we'd run out of the tunnel in the old gym. We'd run out of the locker room in the tunnel, and they would line the court with fans. And Red Oak did that for girls and boys game, and the Hawkeye 8 at the time outlawed it and said, nope, no more fan tunnels on the court pregame. So
you guys were rebels.
We were rebels, man.
Wow. All right. So the hype video is going on.
We have a new music person tonight.
You do? Coach Kipley is usually our musical director.
Janelle Erickson is the maestro of the intro in the pregame here.
I did notice that whenever you came in, you sat down and gave a couple of selections.
I gave some song selections. They were immediately rejected. But that's okay. It's okay.
Well,
I guess they didn't want anything from the 1980s hair band era.
Yeah. All right. Player introductions are being made. So, Matt, again, how much of this comes into rivalries too? I mean, because I always say that when these two teams get together, they just go. This is the game that both of these teams go at. And try
you know,
to win.
When both programs are kind of on the same level, that's when it really cooks well.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
It's right now that you'd have to say the Phillies have the advantage in the girls' program, and of course the boys have the advantage in the boys' program. When you have to have those really spirit, you can think back to Logan Hughes versus was it Kate Walker in that era? I think
and Allie and Sophie.
Yeah, I mean, you think back to those games.
Yeah.
I mean, come on now, that is.
Yeah,
that's rival right there.
Yeah,
yeah, but it's always there. Don't get me wrong, but it's just it's more of a heightened thing when you have teams that are in the same ballpark of whatever their talent level is, you know. And then of course these kids, you know, I was talking to some of the Riddle boys before the game, and they were of course very excited to play tonight, and you know that's good to see. And I'm sure the Shenandoah guys are the same way. They're very excited to play and get on here. Anytime you have a Shenandoah Riddle matchup, it's
do you remember your Shenandoah?
Yeah, we lost the Shenandoah here my senior in the opening game of the year, and we went 0-4, and then we went on a 10-game win streak, and we went down there and beat them about 20 about a month and a half later. But yeah, I mean, it just, I mean, that still sticks to me that we didn't sweep them the senior year, you know. But to their credit, they the Mustangs, you know, got it done. But that's the thing you do, you there's certain teams you remember, like you in high school, your rival. You remember those rival games, good, you know, good or bad, whatever happens in regards to them.
I'm surprised you remember that, Matt.
Well, you know, I'm not ancient. You know, it's not like I'm. You know, it wasn't like we were. playing with, you know, with a two-hand set shot back then, Aaron. I mean,
the old two-hand set shot.
Two-hand set shot, and underhand free throws.
Oh yeah.
Or underhand toss free throws. But,
all right, we're going to have our national anthem. I see it looks like Mr. Olson lining up for that. We're going to step away for our national anthem, and we will be back after this. Make note of our sponsors. Say thank you when you have the opportunity. Quick Legal ID, and we'll be back with the tip. Well, welcome back. Matt, are you ready for some
high school basketball on Tuesday night?
Yep.
A little chilly. It's going to warm up the next couple days, huh?
That's going to warm up a little bit, yeah. At center circle, Lene Green and Jaden Lindsay. For Red Oak?
LeMay Green, she goes 6'1", so she's going to have a significant height advantage. In fact, as I look over kind of the Shenandoah roster, Jenna Burdorf is 5'10", 7'1", so there's a big height advantage here for the Phillies.
What do we have happen there, Matt?
Well, I think the ball was tapped out of bounds by LeMay Green, and I think they're going to say, yeah, it goes to Red Oak here, so they had to confer on that. But Red Oak will get the ball here.
All right.
Here we go. Phillies do open up. Looks like a man-to-man, as I thought they would do. That's going to kind of force Riddick off that three line a little bit.
All right. And I'm going to take one quick break, Matt, and we'll be right back. to Red Oak. Sorry about that. Lene Green at the right elbow. Both teams 0-0, 7:25 to play in the first. Out top, the shot over the right side. Skips it all the way across to Denton for three. No good. Rebound underneath. There's that board and putback, Matt.
Yeah, it's not only that you get inside position with Jaden Lindsay then, but you're going to have to move and back Lene Green out of there because she just went simply over the top there for that. Philly's now in that press there, and they get his turnover right there.
And they push it down.
Red Oak girls got to hustle back on that because Philly's hustled back and got the second, third chance even on that missed layup there. So Tigers got to get back and have a team effort on the glass.
Yeah, 4-0 is our score. We're going to have a travel call.
Yeah, Tigers are, like, as we kind of thought, the Phillies are going to press, and they're going to go man-to-man, and that's what the Tigers are going to face here. So they've got to play through this. Back cuts, good screens for the Tigers here offensively to try to get some shots up.
All right. Out top it goes to Ramirez. Top of the key, over to the left side to Johnson for three. Ellison Johnson, no good. There's Lene Green with the board.
Philly's hustling down the court, too. Tigers get back on that one.
Denton to Green, over the right side now to Stevens. Top of the key to Rogers. Underneath, there's Lene Green again, Matt.
Yeah, and they may have, Coach Johnson may have to go to a front and a back on that low post to take that away. And you got to give up something here. Maybe give up the shooting here to try to take the Green away from the low post.
Down on the left side it goes underneath. Try to get it underneath quickly to Ellison Johnson, but it's a bit out of a reach.
Yeah, just one of those things where, again, you got to know your teammates and what kind of passes they're capable of catching. I know I've said that quite a bit, but can't throw a pass that your teammate can't catch.
All right, here we go. Down in the corner it goes. That's Chloe Denton for three. No good. Rebound Stevens. Cassidy Stevens back around top to Rogers, down underneath quickly to Green, and that's just a force underneath,
yeah.
Matt.
Yeah, I think the key there, once she gets the ball down low post, she's pretty much going to score, so you got to try to deny the ball as much as you can, and Lene, we've seen her have some huge game against Red Oak. She's already has 6 points. Siebenek with a three there.
No good. Rebound pulled down by Rogers. She'll take it across the timeline on the right side to Denton. She loses the handle. It's picked up by Green, and Green puts it up. No good. Grabs her own board. Kicks it out to Stevens on the left side for three. Off the glass, no good. Rebound Rogers this time. Caroline Rogers with the board.
The Tigers are trying to double up on the low post now.
Denton takes it down to the baseline right side. Skips it. That's all the way across to Rogers for three. In and out. Underneath the rebound, Burdorf. Back up, no good. Rebound this time, Stevens, and we have a travel call.
Philly's just all over that offensive glass. They're even without Grant. Coach Johnson's going to call a timeout and talk about this.
We'll take that timeout with them, and we'll be back after this. Welcome back to Red Oak. 4:55 to play in the first, 8-0, and the Phillies have controlled the first portion of this first quarter.
Yeah, they already might be in double digits in offensive rebounds, and Tigers are just going to have to get better on that defensive glass for them.
All right, Tigers with the ball, full court press coming from the Phillies. Jaden Lindsay with the ball back to Ramirez, still in the backcourt.
Got to get across.
Across the timeline on the far side of the court. She tries to get it to Siebenecker, but it's knocked out of play. Burdorf.
And we've seen the Tigers struggle in this man-to-man defense. They need to do some back cuts and hard screens because the teams will overplay on the wing pass. Seeing there was a back cut, but miscommunication there by the Tigers.
Down the other end, layup is off the glass, no good. We're going to have a jump ball.
Good hustle by Olivia Boswell, though, to get back. Philly missed a layup. She was back to tie up on the loose ball, but it will stay. It will go to Red Oak now, possession to Red Oak.
Red Oak's ball at the baseline.
The Phillies are.
Now we're going to have a little confusion here, Matt.
Red Oak ball.
Yeah, Red Oak ball. Okay. But we're all in agreement. All getting the head nod here.
Phillies have beat the Tigers down to four in transition, and on the glass in the first 4 minutes of this game.
Yep. Ramirez to Boswell, still in the backcourt. Pressure. She steps across the center stripe over the right side. We're going to have a foul. I believe Burdorf or Stevens.
Yeah, it could pick either one here. Let's say you're going to go with 21. Stevens.
Cassidy Stevens. She's a senior. 8-0 Shenandoah leads. 4:22 to play in the first. Tigers ball. Inbound pass from Boswell to Siebenecker. Back to Boswell. And she wasn't inbounds before she passed the ball back. And
yeah, just a got to reckon we talked about that on that far side of the court. That stripe, you can kind of lose where you are in perspective in this gym because the stands are not close to that stripe. There's a power move by Green.
Green, yeah, she takes it to the hoop, gets whistled for the travel. Lene Green, she has 6 points here.
Six points of the eight.
Probably
six rebounds. I'm not so sure she didn't set some sort of record against Red Oak against rebounds a couple years ago.
There's Chloe Denton knocking it loose. Goes out of play. The Tigers will maintain, but inbound pass from Ramirez. Into the backcourt to Boswell. Now to Ramirez. Lindsay across the timeline. Still has her dribble, but stripped loose by Rogers. Into the backcourt, chased down by Ramirez.
The Tigers aren't even able to get into their offensive flow here. The Phillies are pushing them so far out on the perimeter.
Ellison Johnson out on
There's
the wing. In the lane, jump shot. Up, no good. Rebound, chased down by Burdorf. Outlet pass goes to Denton. She takes it left to right, down to the left wing, top of the key. Burdorf, right side Stevens. Looking inside. Nothing there. Takes it down to the baseline. Underneath the basket, kicks it out to the corner. Denton for three. Nope. Rebound Burdorf underneath. She's tied up and actually tie up and slide out of play. They're going to call the jump ball first.
I think Coach Johnson is going to want to be making sure he's yelling out 3 seconds tonight because anything he can do to help his team to keep the Shenandoah size away from that basket.
A little substitution taking place here. Inbound
just a
pass.
Good pass from the Phillies there.
Fouch. Who is that?
To
Green?
Green, yeah. Just a little high pass. No one else is going to catch that except Lene. And she got it all in one rhythm and kept the ball up high and puts it in for 2 points. She's got 8 of the 10 Phillies points.
Lindsay with the ball. Back to Ramirez out on the left wing now to Johnson. She takes the three. No good. Rebound underneath. Casey Kells puts it back up and in for two.
I know. Is that an assist? You give an assist to Ellison on that?
Sure. Why not? Fouch with the ball. Round to the left side to Shabam. Back to Fouch. Right side, top of the key, Rogers, deep three. No good. Rebound, Ellison Johnson. She will be fouled from behind, which I think will be Shabam.
You know, Ellison Johnson is a sophomore. I'm going to go and make a prediction.
Alexis
Shabam. When she's a senior, she stays at it, and she continues to play basketball and continue to improve, she's going to merit some sort of all-conference recognition by the time she's a senior. She just has tremendous talent. She just has to work on her shooting. She's got all the other ingredients
Matt, here's the
to
thing.
Be a good basketball player.
She does a great job on the boards, offensive and defensive. Mm-hmm. She gets a lot of really great looks at the basket.
Yep.
When it starts to fall, we're going to have a jump ball.
Yeah. And Red Oaks dribbling into trapping positions right over the half-court line. They need to bring someone up. We talked about this in the other game. Bring someone up in the middle of the court. Get the ball to the middle of the court on that press, and that relieves some of the pressure.
Ramirez will put it into play for Red Oak.
Right now, Ramirez and Boswell are trying to handle bringing the ball up against the press, and you need your forwards to come up to help.
Ellison Johnson takes it around to the right side. There's Ramirez down to the blocks, off the glass. It's in for two from Merced.
Nice hard take there by Ramirez.
And it's 10-4, rather, with 2:26 to play in the first. Shenandoah with the lead off of the hands of the Phillies, and the Tigers will have it.
So, again, Ellison Johnson here is coming up in the middle on this press here. And then they got a pass ahead here.
Boswell, Ramirez. Cross,
there you go. There it is.
Lindsay takes it down to the blocks, so she's met from the pressure. Abigail Martin. Three-pointer from Ramirez is good.
But you can see where that pass in the middle, Aaron, it relieves all the pressure. It collapses everyone off. So that was a good job there by the Tigers, and that's out of bounds. It's going to be
tapped out of play.
Tiger ball.
Yeah, Tiger ball.
Tigers on a 7-0 run here.
10-7 is the score. Shenandoah leads. Inbound pass from Lindsay's full-court press. From the Phillies. Bounce pass, inbound, stripped out of play by Rogers, Caroline Rogers.
And these backcourt players with tires need to come up.
Lindsay will put it into play once again for Red Oak.
Casey Kills has a speed advantage here on Green. And they're
it's on the floor. Boswell comes away with it. She takes it across the center stripe down to the left wing. Now to Ramirez. Minute 56 to play in the first. Ramirez around the arc. Over to the right side to Boswell, or to Ellison Johnson. She shoots the long two. Renee Green goes up and grabs the board. She'll take it. Kicks it on the right side to Rogers. Caroline Rogers off the glass for two.
That was Renee Green leading the fast break there for the Tiger, or for the Phillies, and found her teammate, and Phillies back up by five now.
Lindsay to Ramirez right at the center stripe. Over to the left side it goes to Kells. She takes the three off the left wing. It's not there. Rebound pulled down by Shabam. She takes it left to right across the timeline. Down underneath the Green. She's got the size. Puts it up. No good. Rebound underneath by Abigail Martin. Shot and in by Kylie Fouch for two.
Second shot opportunity there. The Phillies got another rebound, kicked it to the corner, and took full advantage of that. I think they gave her two on that, Aaron.
I think it was two, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought initially it was a three, but it's two.
55 seconds trapped in the corner. Ellison Johnson's trying to get the open player. Tries to get it to Boswell, but a nice job by Caroline Rogers for the steal.
Philly's doing a good job pushing the Tigers to the edges of the perimeters where they can trap.
There's Shabam for three.
Nice shot. She has a really good shooting motion there, and nothing but net on that three-pointer.
Alexis Shabam, 17-7 is our score. Shenandoah leads.
Just like that, the Phillies have moved back out to a 10-point lead. Tigers have cut it to three, but Phillies have the last 5 points here. Tigers with the opportunity to hold the ball here for the last shot of quarter if they want to.
Kylie Fouch gets whistled. That's her first.
27 seconds ago in the first quarter.
I don't think the Tigers have committed a foul yet.
Well, there you go. We'll probably see an offensive charge here.
Into the backcourt to Siebenecker. Almost. Ramirez chases it down into the backcourt. 18 seconds.
Oh, I thought that might have been a double dribble.
She takes it all the way into the lane, puts it up off the glass. No good. Rebound brought down by Abigail Martin. Out to Shabam on the left side. Alexis Shabam in the corner. Shot from Fouch is no good. Rebound Lindsay. That's going to do it for the first quarter. 17-7. Is our score at the end of one, and we'll take a break and be back after this.
Just as your local State Farm agent teams combine good neighbor service with surprisingly great rates, you can combine your home and auto. And guess what you get? That's right, good neighbor service with surprisingly great rates. This is your local State Farm agent, Dave Carbaugh, and we promise to deliver the service you deserve at the price you want. My State Farm team will help you mix and match things perfectly. Call us today at 712-623-5639 for your surprisingly great rates. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
JV. Shenandoah leads 17-7 as we come back to action. Junior varsity boys play, Matt. It was Red Oak over Shenandoah 50-39 in junior varsity boys play.
Here in the second quarter of the varsity girls game, it's Shenandoah 17, Red Oak 7. In that first quarter, you know, Red Oak's really trying in that 2-3 zone to collapse down, and that creates open three-point opportunities for the Phillies. It's hard to cover both. There's a good high-low pass.
Backside, Fouch puts it up, no good. Rebound tapped around. On the court, Fouch comes away with it, puts it back up and in for two.
Just harder scrapping there by the Phillies. Tigers need to be a little tougher down underneath that rim.
Kylie Fouch does a nice job underneath. Lindsay to Boswell across the center stripe. Johnson in the corner. It goes to Grace Wingfield. Picks up her dribble. Now to Siebenecker out on the left wing. It's knocked loose. Fouch comes away with it. I think it was actually knocked loose by Denton, picked up by Fouch. Denton takes it down to the blocks, puts it up, and we're going to have an offensive foul.
Yeah, I think that's a good call there. Olivia got over there in time, got her feet set. Good charge draw there by Olivia. Green is back in now for the Phillies. But, you know, it's hard to press the whole game, Aaron, from the Phillies. They're going to have to substitute in and out. It's a lot of energy. It's a lot of up and down. We've seen teams put it on and take it off, but Phillies have just been really clamping down on that defensive pressure here with the press on the Tigers.
Ramirez with the ball.
It was a good pass ahead.
To Siebenecker in the corner underneath Ellison Johnson, but it's tapped by Burdorf, picked up by Johnson. Lene Green causing problems in the passing lane down there. Boswell with three, no good. Rebound chased down by Denton. She finds Stevens. Cassidy Stevens down to the other end and knocked out of play by Casey Kills.
You know, one thing I'm talking about is the pace of play. And the pace of play, the key has been all Phillies. Even when you break the press, the Tigers get through the press. It rushes you on the offensive end, and seen some quick shots there.
Stevens will put it into play for Shenandoah. Into the corner to Burdorf. Right elbow Green. Back in the corner, Stevens for three. It's good.
That all started with a pass to the high post of Lene Green, and she's with that height, is able to find her teammate in the corner there. Big advantage, that height, to be able to pass that ball around half court there. Phillies really operating well offensively.
Out on the right side to Boswell behind the arc. There's Ramirez. She fakes it, top key. Kells for three. In and out. No good. Rebound. Fought for. There's Ellison Johnson. She's going to be whistled for the travel.
Now, there was a hard strap by Ellison that ripped the ball away but took an extra step there. But nice shot by Kesey Kells. Kesey had a good game last night against Essex, and she's really being assertive with her shot. When she sees it open, she's going to take it.
22-7 is our score. Shenandoah with the lead with 6:13 to play in the half. Down underneath the green, and that's tough to stop right there.
Yeah, she got inside position, and her teammate found her open. And it's an advantage. You can throw the ball up high, and Lene does a good job of catching it high, keeping it high, not bringing it back down. We've seen so many tall players. They get the ball there, and yep, they bring it back down. And
they give away all their height advantage.
Exactly, but she does not. She does a great job, and green. There she is.
She knocking
on the free throw. She has 11 points on the night so far for the Phillies.
25-7 is the score. It's just over 6 minutes to play in the half. Ramirez to Kells. Now to Ramirez. And it's going to be stolen by Stevens. She was almost a back cut there by Boswell, Matt.
Yeah. Tigers really having a tough time offensively with the press and the man-to-man defense.
Out to Green behind the arc. Stevens left wing down the corner. Fouch. Back to Stevens. Into the lane she goes. Strip loose by Siebenecker, picked up by Kells.
Good job there by Kesey Kells. She's usually good for a couple, two or three steals each game.
Ramirez to Boswell, top the key, Kells.
You can tell the Tigers just a little disjointed on offense here.
Out on the right side to Boswell. Behind the arc, she goes into the lane, kicks it out to Kells, who looks at the three. 5:16 to play in the half. Siebenecker with the ball. Back to Ramirez behind the arc. Well behind the arc.
8 seconds
right
on the shot clock, Aaron.
Kells puts it up from three. No good. Rebound.
It's gonna
knocked
stay
out
with
of play. Yeah, Tigers are going to keep it. Denton and Burdorf both went for it, and it goes out of play. Coming into the game, Caroline Rogers taking a seat is Fouch, Kylie Fouch. Inbound pass will come from Ramirez at the baseline for Red Oak. Just over 5 minutes to play in the half. 25-7 is the score. Shenandoah leads. Boswell to Siebenecker, top of the key, takes the three. No good. Rebound Stevens, tied up by Siebenecker, but we're going to have a foul on the play, I believe.
Get over back there by Emily. It'll be only the second team foul on Rutgers.
They called that on Kesey Kells, man.
Ooh, I didn't see that.
That's who he called it on. 25-7 is the score with 4:50 to play in the half. Stevens with the ball. Across the center stripe. Into the lane. Loses the handle. Picked up by Ramirez. Now to Boswell.
Phillies still in the man-to-man. Merced with a three.
No good. There's Lene Green with the board. Gets it to Stevens. Stevens left to right. Across center stripe. Far side of the court. Down to the left wing. Picks up her dribble. Back to Rogers. Rodgers comes around the arc, back to Stevens, underneath
good
it goes.
Good ball movement.
Burdorf scores a couple.
Good ball movement. The Phillies do a great job in the low post, sealing on the post so they can get that pass and have a good layup there. Good job by the Phillies.
27-7 is the score with 4:05 to play in the half. Phillies lead. Shot from Siebenecker is no good. Rebound, Burdorf.
Tigers just cold from that three-point line tonight, Aaron, and that's what the man-to-man defense will do to you. Good hands there by Merced to knock it out of bounds.
Stevens goes into lane, then tries to go down to low post to Green. But
you know, when you go against the zone defense, you're more likely to be able to get your feet set and get a nice pass and get a shot up. But on a man-to-man defense, if you get open threes, you're usually on the move and you got to shoot on the move. And that's a tougher look from the three than it is against the zone look.
Okay, I think we're set, ready to go from the baseline. Shabam out to Rodgers, back to Shabam in the corner for three. Nope. Rebound Burdorf on the backside. She puts it back up. Ramirez is there to block it and take it. Right to left, top of the key. Ramirez with the ball underneath to Lindsay. She spins and will be fouled by Green.
I'm not sure if Jaden meant to do a pump fake there with the ball, but she kind of did it anyway. But that's one way you neutralize a taller player is to use something like that to try to get them up in the air a little bit. That's Green's first foul of the game.
Ramirez from the baseline for Red Oak. Trying to find the open Tiger all the way out top to Siebenecker. Kells right side. Ramirez out on the right wing. 3:30 to play in the half. Down underneath the Lindsay, and it's knocked loose. Coming away with it was Martin. She gets it to Shabam. Shabam takes it across center. Stewart, top key. Martin.
One thing the Tigers make is there's a three.
Shabam in and out. No good. Rebound batted around. Chased down by Ramirez. She is tied up. Abigail Martin.
One thing the Tigers may want to consider an offense is I know they run through a, you know, traditionally have a low post player, but they may want to slide Jaden Lindsay out away from the bucket, put her in the corner, see if that draws Green away from the bucket a little bit. That would open up the lane a little bit. But, you know, you're used to your normal offense and you have a low post player in a wing and a guard. But it'd be interesting to see if Green goes out and follows Lindsay if they do it. Now, it looks like the Phillies might be going, no, they're still in man. So let's see if Jaden goes to the corner here and if Green follows out.
Three shot attempt there by Boswell. No good. Rebound Burdorf. Out the pass comes to Shabam. Looking down the court, but it's not there. She spins her way into the lane and gets up with the ball and travels.
Nice spin move there, but I'd say she got a couple extra dance steps in there.
2:50 to play in the half. It's 27-7 is our score. Shenandoah with the lead. Varsity girls play. Siebenecker takes it into the lane, puts up the shot, and rebound pulled down by Green. I thought she was going to pass, to be honest with you.
Yeah, but she just kind of flipped it up there and almost went in.
Down underneath it goes to Green. She puts it up and in for two.
You got to be aware where Green is all the time. She just simply ran down the court in the middle of the lane and got a
– She has 13.
Again, just a high pass and a high shot. She didn't even bring it down.
She has 13 points in the ballgame so far. Down in the corner goes to Kells, but it's just out of her reach and goes out of play.
Red Oak has gone. I do not believe they've scored in this quarter yet, so the Phillies have really clamped down. What was it, 12-7?
17-7 at the end of the first.
Yeah, so the Tigers have yet to get any points here. The Phillies have really dominated the second quarter.
2:11 to play in the half. Down to the corner goes to Denton, knocked out of play. Ramirez, Phillies will keep it. 2:07 to play in the half. 29-7, Shenandoah with the lead.
Timeout. Red Oak.
Timeout on the court. We'll keep it or we'll take it with them. 2:07 to play in the half. 29-7, Phillies lead.
Too busy at work to wait in a long line at Subway? Order online at order.subway.com. Simply register with your email and password and order away. You can also download the Subway app on your smartphone. Order up to 6 subs, salads, or pizza. Ready in 15 minutes once order is submitted. Also add chips, cookies, and drinks easily. And Subway's back to normal hours Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 11 p.m., Saturday, 8 a.m. to 11 p.m., and Sunday, 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. Order online at Subway in Red Oak, Clarinda, Shenandoah.
Red Oak, 2:07 to play in the half, 29-7. Lene Green with the Phillies has 13 points.
My guess is she already has a double-double. I'm sure she has 10-plus rebounds already.
She's had quite a few rebounds.
Yep.
Quite a few. Here we go. Back to action. Phillies have the ball. Inbound pass comes from Denton to Stevens. Back to Denton, right wing for three. In for 3 points. Chloe Denton.
Yeah, Tigers just did not react defensively there.
And it's 32-7 now. Shenandoah with the lead. Out on the right side to Kells, Boswell. There's Ramirez. She takes the three from the top off the glass. No good. Rebound pulled down by Shabam. Alexis Shabam. Stevens down to the right wing. Inside it goes to Martin, Abigail Martin. Stevens for three off the right wing. No good. Rebound, Kells. Casey Kells.
Phillies have pretty much gone back just solely man-to-man in the half court now.
Ramirez around the arc. Kicks it back to Ellison Johnson. Boswell for three.
Olivia gets her first three of the night. Olivia is one of the leaders in the Hawk 10 in three-point shooting. She's been shooting the ball well from three all year.
Just over a minute to play in the half. Down underneath the green in the blocks. She takes it underneath and puts it up for two more.
She improved her positioning with that. She took a couple of little dribbles to improve her angle on the board, and nicely done there.
34-10 is the score. Shenandoah with the lead. Left side to Boswell, underneath to Lindsay in the blocks, left side.
And that's kind of like I say, there's not going to be much there low with Jaden against Green. I'd move her away from that bucket there, try to get Green out to the corner.
Ramirez takes it down to the baseline, right side, back top key to Kells, 27 seconds. Boswell's open for three, no good. Rebound, Lindsay, nope. Ellison Johnson and Green tie up. Jump ball, Shenandoah's ball. 18 seconds remaining in the half.
Actually a pretty good offensive possession there by the Tigers. Good ball movement. Kicked it in, kicked it back out, but nothing to show for it.
17 seconds and counting. Shenandoah's going to play for one final shot here. 12 seconds down the corner to Green. Stevens, corner to Denton. Underneath to Green, 5 seconds. Dumps it to Martin. She puts it up out to Stevens from the free throw line. As the buzzer sounds, that's going to do it for the first half. 34-10. 34-10 at half here in Red Oak. Shenandoah with the lead. We'll take a break. We'll be back after this.
Farming isn't just your livelihood, it's your life. No one understands that better than Farm Bureau Financial Services. We offer comprehensive coverage that protects your farm. Get customized coverage on one policy with one and one deductible when you need it the most. Contact Farm Bureau agents Bruce Bryant or Jamie Sifford in Red Oak and learn more about smarter insurance for agriculture.
Farm Bureau Property and Casualty Insurance Company, Western Agricultural Insurance Company.
Go man-to-man and that sort of stuff. You know, the pace of play, it's hard to control the pace of play when you're being pressed.
Yeah.
And what have you. But, you know, I think the Tigers, they have had some good looks from the three, but they're different types of looks. Then they got in against the zone. So credit the Phillies. Really good job. It's really hard to cover in that zone, to cover down low post, and then get back out to their three line. That's the good beauty of having an inside-outside game. You can really play off each other, and Shenandoah is really humming offensively in that first half with 34 points. I'm trying to see what Shenandoah's high. Let's know if they have scored. Let's see what they're averaging. They're averaging 41 points per game, so they're going to go well above that in game. But
let's take a quick break here, Matt, and we'll be back after these messages. Shenandoah leads at half.
Hey, Sunshine Country, it's Cheryl Porter. Do you like your job? How would you like to love your job? Fresco System USA is looking for several highly motivated workers to join our team. Come see me at 2026 Fernwood Avenue in Red Oak or call 712-623-8100, extension 6659, and we can talk about everything we offer, like benefits starting day one and so much more. So if you're ready to love your job, come see me today at Fresco System USA. Love is in the air.
Oh, no. 2, 4, 6, 8.
I wish we had a...
Stadium 34 in Red Oak, proudly serving delicious food and drinks to all of Sunshine Country. From your favorite craft beer with a burger to a perfectly grilled ribeye steak and a glass of wine. They have a great selection on their menu. Stadium 34 also serves breakfast Saturday and Sunday mornings. And if you need a space for a wedding reception, anniversary party, family reunion or birthday party, Seating 34 has the perfect banquet space for a large or small event. Call today to book your party. That's Stadium 34 at the Red Coach Inn on Senate Avenue in Red Oak.
For over 50 years, Heinlein Home Furnishings have served customers in Missouri and Iowa with our large in-stock selection or our custom order program. Our no-pressure sales and delivery team is always available to help you find items that'll make your home look beautiful. With over 80,000 feet of gorgeous furniture and flooring, check out one of our three locations today, Maryville, Missouri, or Harlan in Shenandoah, Iowa. Heinlein is here to help our neighbors have beautiful homes.
Why?
Subscribe to the KCSI Radio YouTube channel today. Interviews, parades, events, contests, and more. Subscribe to KCSI Radio on YouTube and get notified every time something fun happens.
Welcome back to Red Oak Halftime Varsity Girls Play. Let me give you a rundown of what has occurred here this evening. Now, in junior varsity girls play in two quarters, Matt, it was Red Oak over Shenandoah 19-15. That was in junior varsity girls play in two quarters. Junior varsity boys play in a full game, it was Red Oak over Shenandoah 50-39 in junior varsity boys play. Halftime of varsity girls, Shenandoah leads 34-10, and it's been pretty much all Shenandoah here in the first half. Chloe Denton with 3 points for the Phillies. Alexis Shabam with 3 points. Caroline Rogers, 2 points. Cassidy Stevens with 5 points. Jenna Burdorf, 2 points. Kylie Fouch has four. Lene Green has 15 points, and I don't keep up with rebounds, but she has a number of rebounds for the Phillies. For the Red Oak Tigers, Olivia Boswell with 3 points. Casey Kells has 2 points, and Merced Ramirez with five. That rounds out the scoring for the Red Oak Tigers. Neither team in foul trouble at this point, Matt.
No, yeah, I've been, from that perspective, a pretty clean game, but from a turnover perspective, the Phillies press has really bothered the Tigers, and that man-to-man defense the Phillies have been doing also in the half court has been very effective. And, of course, like we said, Lene Green with her presence down low has been huge.
Yeah.
It's not just the points she gets, but everything kind of revolves around her. Even when she's out top, she's very good about passing and facilitating the ball. I mean, the whole offense works because of her low post scoring ability.
Yep, absolutely.
Everything plays off that.
And it works well.
Yeah, and that's why she's an all-conference player. She's just a junior, so a tremendous ball player, a good ball player to have in your program. I was looking at they've got three seniors at Bert. Who are their seniors? Burdorf, Stevens, and Rogers, and then Denton's a junior, Green's a junior, and then we've seen Shabam. She's a junior. She's been playing some as well. So they're gonna, Phillies have good ball players coming back next year as well with arguably the one of the best players in the Hawkeye 10.
We'll take a break. We're at halftime. Shenandoah with the lead, 34-10 at half, and we will be back after this.
Aaron. We have evidently two new rookie broadcasters that have decided that they are going to replace us.
Okay.
Well, I've noticed down in the student section there was two guys doing the game live, and I said, "What is going on down there? What is this, Perrin and Ty Jenkins?"
It's ESPN night, baby.
Yes, sir.
So they have their booth set up down there, Matt, with their headsets on. You guys calling the game?
Calling the game?
Oh, yeah.
We're calling the game on an Instagram Live.
They're going to beat our ratings. We have student body here doing. They have their fan section down there. I mean, do you have any catchphrases? You got to have some catchphrases. Like, it's cooler than the other side.
Here's what I want to know. I want to know some analysis. What do you see here in the first half?
We're down by little, as you can see.
Were you guys watching? You got to watch the game when you're broadcasting, guys. That's the first down. Thing.
We got here. Oh. Broadcast was run a little bit late. So.
We can definitely come back.
We're down.
We just gotta play a lot more aggressive. I've noticed they've been definitely getting a lot more rebounds than us.
Are you excited for the boys' game? Potential Red Oak history tonight with Max DeVries.
I know. Yeah. That's exciting.
Yeah, it is really exciting.
We'll have to get your call on this, but do we get these guys on camera?
We got them on camera. They're on camera. Yeah. All right. Well, there you go.
Okay, guys. Well, I guess we got competition here.
So here's the analysis that we can come back, and they're down by a little.
They're down by a little.
All right. Yes. Good deal. All right.
We'll come back.
Spot on, guys. Thank you. There you go.
Thank you, guys.
Ty Jenkins and Nolan Perrin with
us. Nolan Perrin with his own headsets.
Yes.
I'm not sure what his headsets are hooked into.
Thank you, guys.
He's got his own headsets.
That's fun, Matt.
Yeah.
There you go.
ESPN announcers.
It's ESPN night, apparently. Yeah. Who knew?
But there they are, the announcers for the new announcers for the Red Oak Tigers, Ty Jenkins and Nolan Perrin.
Oh, that's fun. All right.
And their analysis is Red Oak's down a little.
And they can come back.
And they can come back, according to...
And they need to play more aggressive. That was the analysis from.
Okay. Actually, it's probably better than ours.
Well, there you go.
More concise and to the point. Why put a lot of sugar on it? Just say what it is. Although I'd say they're not down a little. They're down significantly.
Here we go.
Yeah, Red Oak will get the ball to start the second half here. 34-10. Shenandoah on top of Red Oak here as we start the second half of this varsity girls game.
Yep, Red Oak will have the ball. Inbound pass will come from Ellison Johnson, midcourt, far side, into Ramirez. Here we go. Second half is underway. Ellison Johnson.
Phillies in man-to-man. Johnson with the shot.
No good. Rebound Ramirez. Steve steps back underneath, and it's going to be through the hands of Boswell. Picked up by Rogers, Caroline Rogers. Back to Stevens, into the lane. Stevens to Murdorf on the move, blocked by Lindsay. Back out to Lene Green, 10-footer, no good. Rebound Johnson.
And if you're a Tigers, that's where you preferably would want Green to shoot the ball away from the rim there, and it can be a travel on the Tigers there.
Yep.
These unforced turnovers, I think, are what Coach Johnson really wants to clean up, trying to not give the ball over just on what we call, you know, turnovers that are the doing of the Tigers. So let's see if the Tigers can clean that up a little bit here in the second half.
Down underneath the Rogers, she spins, puts it off the glass. It's knocked out of play. That actually kept in play by Lene Green, and then Burdorf drops the three.
Yeah, nice save there by Green directly to Burdorf, who knocks down the three.
And it's 37-10 now with 7 minutes to play in the third. Tapped. Denton headed down for the layup on the left side, puts it up, no good. It's going to be stripped out of play. Siebenecker grabbed the board, and then it was knocked out of her hands and goes out of play.
The Tigers have got to get back down, and still you got to hustle back down the other end. Philly's going, not doing it, in the not pressing, going only man-to-man half court here, and there's another kind of pass that just wasn't there. I think the Tigers are trying to force things too much here, Aaron, offensively. The worst thing you do if you don't get a shot off in 35 seconds, you run the clock for 35 seconds. Just good passes. And there's going to be a foul on the Phillies.
The foul's on Burdorf.
Side out of bounds actually underneath the hoop.
Yeah, Ramirez will put it into play for Red Oak. 6:45 to play in the third. Merced Ramirez at the baseline to Siebenecker in the corner. It's Boswell at the foul line. Siebenecker, she puts up the three. Emily Siebenecker.
Emily knocks down a three for the Tigers.
37-13, Shenandoah with the lead. Down underneath to Lene Green in the blocks, then in the corner, Stevens for three.
And that three was opened by three Tigers around Green.
Yeah, Green goes up. She draws the foul.
It's kind of like shooting ducks from the free line. You just got a free shot there because the Tigers are really converging. Green will go and shoot two shots here at the line.
Siebenecker gets whistled for the foul. That's her first, and it's going to send Lene Green to the line. She's one of one, has 15 points in the game. This one's good. And it's 38-13. Second shot from Green is no good. Rebound, chase down. Nice job by Caroline Rogers. Stevens, she slows it, lets the traffic clear. Right side, hands it off to Rogers. In lane to Denton, quickly out to Stevens. Nice ball movement. Shot off the glass, no good. Rebound on the backside. Burdorf with the left hand.
Yeah, Burdorf is all over the backboards as well. You can see why the Phillies average 41 rebounds per game. They just really attack the glass.
Siebenecker for three from the top. It's no good. Goes out of play, and the Phillies will have it.
Phillies going to be a solid team in the Hawk 10. They're going to be right kind of middle of the pack, good team, and they've got a good blend of, like you say, offense. They can do inside or outside game.
Three-pointer from Rogers hits the side of the backboard. No good. Rebound Ramirez. Ramirez across the timeline. Shot from Siebenecker. Jump ball. Lindsay and Burdorf tie up, and the Phillies have it. 5.5 minutes to play in the third. Cassidy Stevens with the ball across the center stripe. Over the left side to Denton. Top the key to Rogers. Right side Stevens. She skips it across. Underneath it goes to Lene Green in the block. She puts it in for two.
That was a beautiful entry pass. She threw the ball to the perfect position where Green had her hand up in the air away from the defender. So all she had to do was catch it and turn around. That was a perfect entry pass.
Ellison Johnson out on the right wing. In the corner to Lindsay. Out of Ramirez. Kind of loses a handle. Rogers pushed it up the court quickly. Bounce pass to Burdorf for two off the right side this time.
And a nice pass by Rogers, leading her teammate on that pass, on that fast break, where she could catch it and continue in stride to the bucket for a layup.
44-13 is the score. Shenandoah with the lead with 4.5 minutes to play in the third. From the foul line.
Nice drive there by Emily Siebenecker. I love that. She came hard on the drive, pulled up, and knocks it down. Good play there by Emily Siebenecker. Red Oak.
Stevens, Siebenecker. Out on the left side it goes to Denton for three. No good. Rebound chased down the corner by Ellison Johnson. She takes it across the center stripe. Pressure from behind. Nice hustle there by Denton to go end-to-end and knock it out of play.
You can see Ellison was coming down under control. Just think she's got a big upside potential to play well basketball. I hope she shoots the ball a lot this summer and plays some club basketball, because she can be a good one for the Tigers.
Inbound pass will come from Ramirez at the baseline to Boswell. She'll take the three off the right side. Not there. It's going to go out of play. Nice, Phillies ball.
Nice hustle by Jaden Lindsay. You know you're always going to get effort out of Jaden Lindsay, and she just hustles and plays so hard, and very just a great attribute, great role model for her teammates.
Fouch inside to Martin, then out to Shabam. Top the key to Fouch. Over to the left side to Pickens. Fouch for three.
Ooh, kind of a flat shot there, but man, it went in.
Kylie Fouch. She has 7 points in the game.
Yeah, nice. It does not matter how it looks, Aaron, as long as it goes through the bucket.
And it's 47-15 now.
Yeah, and that's.
Here's Siebenecker again. She likes that kind of running jumper.
We had an Essex player last night that shot moon balls, and they would go in. It doesn't matter how it goes in, as long as it does.
Fouch again with a three, no good. Rebound Boswell. Out on the left side to Ramirez, across the center stripe, far side to Siebenecker. She takes a three off the left wing, off the glass this time. Rebound Pickens. Sarah Pickens. Underneath the Green, she dumps it off the foul. It's pretty unselfish there, Green. She maybe should have taken that shot.
Oh, look, that was going to be a jump ball or travel or something. Yeah. Tiger's got a hand in her. Green went up, but Tiger had a hand in her, caused the travel. But, yeah, Green had a shot there, but she deferred to another teammate. But
I mean, Green has 18 points in the game.
And they will come out of the game now, so. Burdorf will play the kind of center defensive position here for the Mustangs or Phillies.
3 minutes to play in the third. And Ellison Johnson from the left elbow. No good. Lindsay with the board underneath. Siebenecker, it's blocked by Burdorf, but Burdorf is whistled for the foul. That's two on Burdorf.
Two shots for Emily here.
2:49 to play in the third. 47-39. Shenandoah with the lead. Emily Siebenecker at the line. Emily has 5 points. This is her first opportunity from the foul line this evening. Shot's no good. Emily, a sophomore, Matt.
Yeah, and again, she's another, you know, her and Ellison are really, as sophomores, have seen so much varsity playing experience, and we've seen their games come so far from last year, and that's a good sign for the Tigers to have two good young players in a program like that.
Pickens to Shabam. She drives the baseline. Nice move by Shabam off the glass.
Yeah, she got around the player there and stayed under control to not commit a charge and got the bucket.
Ramirez at the top of the key. He goes left to Siebenecker. Picked up at the foul line, Johnson. Back to Siebenecker. Kells takes it down to the baseline on the right side. Back to Siebenecker. She's looking across at Ellison Johnson. Now to Kells, who has the running jumper again. And
that's going to be two shots.
Foul on Burdorf. That's number three on Jenna Burdorf.
Wingfield in for Siebenecker now. At least I thought it was two shots.
Grace Wingfield.
That's going to be on the side. Okay, they're going to say the foul was on the ground, so it'll be Red Oak ball inbounds.
Ramirez will put it into play from the baseline for Red Oak. When you have the opportunity, say thanks to our sponsors, both online and on air. We appreciate it, making it possible for us to be here. Down underneath it goes to Lindsay. It's knocked out of play by Burdorf.
Have you seen these guys down there? They've got their own little camera set up. I mean, they've got their – what are they doing down there? They got a microphone there. Look at these guys.
This is really getting to you here,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, they're really – they're – oh, there's a
– knocked out of play.
That might be a foul. I guess that's a non-call there, so I'd be Shenandoah basketball. They're right down in action down there, right behind the bench.
They are, yeah.
Maybe we'll have to employ them as a sideline reporter.
You think so? Yeah. They had some really good analysis.
Yeah.
Red Oak is down by a little, but they can come back.
That sounds a little bit of like a hometown call that's saying they're down by a little.
They're down by a little. Dummler with the ball inside to Burdorf, puts it up, gets her own board back up, and Burdorf, I believe, will go to the line for two, Matt.
Boxing out. Tigers have got to work on that. Boxing out. Don't worry about where the ball goes. Find the body and get into that body and block.
Oh. Yeah, we have a equipment malfunction here by the official.
I think the whistle broke. I think the official's whistle broke, came off.
Broke his whistle. There has to be a joke in there somewhere.
I don't know.
But who was the foul on?
That I don't know. I was busy watching what was happening here with the officials.
Burdorf at the line. Shots up. It's no good. Jenna Burdorf, she two-shot opportunity. First shot was no good. Second shot snaps the net. 50-35.
So I think we're in a
continuous clock.
Continuous clock situation now.
Left side, it goes to Grace Wingfield.
Math is not my area. So
top of the key to Ramirez. She takes the three. It's good.
Now we're not in a running clock situation. But I defer to you, Aaron. I defer to you, Aaron, on that.
Dummler puts up the three. Once it goes to a continuous clock, does it stay with a continuous clock?
I don't think so. I think once you go back under, it needs to stop, doesn't it? I don't know.
To the rules committee.
What do you think I am, some basketball?
Sports guy?
Sports guy. I don't know rules.
A minute to play in the third. Wingfield, Grace Wingfield with the ball. Ramirez looks at the, she's way out there. Down underneath the Lindsay, but it's out of her reach and goes out of play. Well, the Phillies have the ball.
Well, the clock is still running. So
that's, I think that, once you cross that threshold.
So even if you come back and lead the game, it still runs?
Well, I don't.
There's got to be some rule
on
that.
I don't think that's the case. I think once you cross the threshold, up 35 in the second half.
Wow. See, you learn something every night.
Text me. Somebody needs to text me and let me know.
Someone who actually understands high school basketball and knows the rules, please text us. And
Fouch
clarify that.
To Burdorf, back to Fouch behind the arc.
Oh, good steal there by
Ramirez. Ramirez knocks it loose, picked up by Boswell. 19 seconds and counting in the third. Ramirez with the ball. Takes it down lane on left side. Fouch strips it loose, picked up by Kells. She puts it up with 10 seconds. No good. There's Boswell with the board and the putback. Olivia Boswell.
Olivia with the bucket and
50-20. That's the end of the third. Shenandoah leads 50-20 at the end of three, and we will be back after this. Did we get a ruling?
We've heard from our rules expert, David Berge Berger, and he says he thinks it's got to go back to 25 differential for it to stop.
Okay. There you go.
I suppose I could just yell down to the scoreboard and ask them. They know what they're doing. But why would we want to do that?
See, that would just way easier just to speculate and talk about it. That's what you do, right?
Just speculate.
I watched a little bit of that selection committee show this past weekend.
Football.
About 45 minutes is about all I could take, but that's just a lot of speculation and
conjuncture. And
yeah,
so the clock is stopped.
It is.
No, now it's running.
Yeah, it's yeah.
It did stop, but now it's running.
Well, the ball's in play.
Well, it wasn't. I don't know.
Boswell down at the baseline, picks it up, kicks it to now Natalie Johnson. Lene Greig comes away with it. Alapass quickly to Rogers.
Oh, great hustle by Casey Kells.
Lene Greig took a spill, Matt, and slid like.
She made a heck of a pass from a mid-court stripe to their teammate.
She got tickled at herself.
Yeah, but she took a header, and then Casey Kells hustled back, knocked it away. Now the clock has stopped. No, the clock is running. Timeout. We got a timeout here.
Yeah, I think.
I think Casey is bleeding.
Yeah, she took,
a header there.
Shot. All right.
And she's hurting a little bit. She's all right. She's a tough gal.
Yeah. All right. I tell you what, we'll take the. We'll just keep it here.
Yeah, we'll keep it here. Here comes Berge in into the gymnasium.
You have me all.
I don't know. Watch the clock. I think it's been stopping and starting.
You have me all rattled here with all
this.
You
would think we could figure this out by just watching the clock. But, you know,
there's Berge. Ask Berge.
He's
50-20 is 50 to fourth quarter. I wonder. We need to get a rules evaluation from our ESPN sideline crew.
It looks like they're bringing more newscasters into their
students. Green.
So here we go. Inbounds Phillies to now Green.
To Green at the right elbow. Hands it off to Rogers. She looks inside. Good goes look. Inside underneath the Burdorf. Nice play.
Nice look there. Set play coming out of timeout there. And Phillies score.
52-20 is our score. 6:58 to play in the ball game. Siebenecker. 10-foot jumper. No good. Rebound Green. She pushes it quickly across the timeline. End to end. Board to board. Off the glass and scores two.
Yeah, Lene really showing good ball handling skills there. That's the second or third time we've seen her kind of lead the team down the court in the charge to the bucket.
Out on the left side to Siebenecker. Now to Boswell. 6.5 minutes to play in the ball game. Boswell
nice.
Puts it off the glass for two and draws the foul.
Nice job there by Olivia. How many points does Olivia have tonight? He's average, coming in averaging 11 per game.
Fouls on Cassidy Stevens. She has 5-7 points here in the ballgame.
So the clock is running.
It is. Shot was up, no good from Boswell. Cassidy Stevens with the ball for Shenandoah. Comes around to the left side, left wing. Keeps the dribble. Top of the key, Denton. Stevens in the corner to Rogers. Rogers to Stevens. In the lane she goes. Stripped by Siebenecker. Emily stops. Gets it to Lindsay, and Lindsay wasn't quite ready for it. Bounces loose, and the Phillies come away with it. Out of the corner to Stevens. Underneath to Green. She spins, puts it off the glass, and scores two. Lene Green.
Well, we had our, of all people, we've had our volleyball color commentator decided to go to the rule book.
There you go.
Texted me the rule that it does just stay in effect.
There you go.
It's from our volleyball. He's probably drinking his Perrier water.
Oh, gosh. Listen to you.
I'm sure he's taking some sort of limousine to the game tonight.
Shot goes up. No good. Foul Ramirez. I'm going to have to separate my two color guys now.
Well, you know the volleyball guys. I mean, they're just, I mean.
I'm going to have to separate you two. That foul was on Ramirez. That's Merced's first personal foul of the evening. It's going to send Chloe Denton to the line. This is Chloe's first opportunity from the line. Shot's no good.
I mean, it's just a difference. I mean, I'll have to study up on volleyball rules here. And I don't even want to recognize his name on the
broadcast. We're not even in volleyball season here. My shot from Denton is good. 57-22 is our score. Tigers with the ball. 5 minutes of play in the ball game. On the left side to Boswell. Underneath to Ramirez. She puts it up from right in front of the basket. No good. Rebound tapped, and Shabam comes away with it. She lets the traffic clear. Now she'll take it across the center stripe. Shabam with the ball. Top of the key. Down underneath to Martin. There's Pickens. Shabam, top of the key.
And one thing I noticed about the Phillies players, they're very good at dribbling and ball handling, and that's kind of the skill that the Tigers need to learn. They need to play more to be able to get better with the dribble drive and the ability, not just the dribble, but to dribble in traffic and going down court. That comes with more gameplay experience, more practice.
Dumbler puts up the three. No good. Rebound Ramirez for Red Oak. 4:18 to play in the ballgame. Down to Lindsay. She gets whistled for the travel, I believe. Yeah.
Great pass there. That was a pass that led her teammate right to the bucket. That was a very good pass by Merced there. Just unfortunately, Jayden took an extra step.
Shabam with the ball. She'll take it across the center stripe.
Don't you just want to say Shabam, Shabam?
The shot goes up. No good. Rebound put back and in. I think Dumbler with that. You have me singing over here. Dumbler.
Looks like Coach Johnson's going to clear the bench here for the last 3 minutes of the game, bringing in those reserves.
Ramirez takes it to the hoop. She's fouled Martin, I believe. Nope, check that. It's going to be on Fouch. That's her second personal foul.
So Merced will have two shots here for the Tigers.
Merced Ramirez at the line. First shot from the line for Merced this evening. In and out. No good.
My volleyball commentator is Bergie is now also sending me the rule in the rule book. I suppose we should have a rule book up here, shouldn't we?
Second shot from Ramirez is no good.
I mean, phone a friend, ask the audience. That's probably not good commentary to be asking the audience for rule clarifications. Probably not
three and a half minutes.
Not the way to do it.
Yeah, but it's more fun.
There you go.
59-22 is the score with 3:20 to play in the ballgame and counting. Caden Nograce Wingfield with the ball.
Ryberg in here for the Tigers. She shoots one up there.
Snaps the net.
Haley Ryberg, she scored last night against Essex. She drops in, and that's probably her first three-pointer of varsity career right there. So
Shabam Pickens.
She's in the score sheet.
in the lane and drops the jumper.
Nice job there.
Sarah Pickens. Grace Wingfield with the ball down the left side of the lane. Spins, puts it off the glass. No good. Rebound taken by Callie Bebout. Down in the blocks on the left side for two. Callie Bebout picks
left
up.
Left-hand shot there. I don't know if she's left-handed, but she hit a left-hand layup there. We're going to have a substitute in for the Phillies here.
Nora Martin for Abigail Martin. 2:20 and counting. 63-25 is the score.
I'd like to see the Wingfields getting the score sheet here. Let's see if Grace or King can get a shot here. Take it right there.
Grace from the top of the key. Left side to Ellison Johnson.
Ryberg
for three. It's no good.
We need to fix the net down here on this end. And that is
Ramirez
hung up on the rim.
Ryberg for three. No good. Rebound Ramirez again. Out to Ellison Johnson. She takes it into the lane. Ryberg for three.
She keeps shooting.
Oh, good. Rebound pulled down by Shabam. A minute 43 to play in the ballgame. 63-25. Down the corner it goes to Dumbler. Inside, kind of bounces through the lane, really, and is chased down at the center line by Shabam. Now to Pickens, over to the right side to Dumbler. Inside to Martin, Nora Martin. Dumbler for three. It's good.
Phillies, a lot of the Phillies reserves scoring here, so good for Coach Heinrich to get his squad, some younger players, some court time here.
66-25, 1 minute and 12 seconds to play.
So the Phillies will go to 2-3 on the year.
Ellison Johnson spins, puts it up, and gets two.
Ellison Johnson.
First points of the night for Ellison.
Good to see Ellison get on the scoreboard.
56 seconds and counting. 66-27 is the score. We're going to have a travel in the lane. Tigers ball. Fouch into the game. And Shabam takes a seat. Inbound pass to Wingfield. 30 seconds. Wingfield takes it down to the baseline. Back to Ryberg. Over to Ramirez. She is fouled by Dumbler. 19 seconds and counting here.
So a good win for the Phillies here tonight.
Looks like our final will be 66-27, but we'll get that officially here in just a second. Wingfield, foul line, puts it up. No good.
Shoot that
Ramirez, that's going to do it. 66-27.
This
is our final. Take a quick break, and we will be right back after this. Here's Tristan Johnson with us now. Coach Johnson, talk to me about what you saw from your Tigers here tonight.
It was a tough one tonight. I think that we just, you can tell we haven't had a lot of practice time. We played three games last week. We started this week with two games. We got two practice and we got another game.
Yeah.
We got to get back into working on some things. Tonight I thought we got outworked a little bit. They boxed out a little harder than us. They ran the floor a little bit harder than us. And that's going to happen with games. You're tired. We played five games.
Yeah.
We got to get back to where we can practice, slow things down a little bit, get back to basics, work a little bit harder, and then hopefully we can
I'm assuming you knew they'd come out in a man-to-man and full-court press. And I thought, well, he settled in a little bit more and right there in the first quarter, the three-point game, and they went on a little bit of run there and got some separation on you. But I thought you played pretty well once you, in the second half, settled down and took care of the ball. And
Yeah. I mean, we knew they were gonna press us a little. I kind of expected them to go a full court press rather than that three-quarter press. It kind of hurt us a little. We were a little off balance because we were expecting them to be right on us, and nobody was there. That's probably a little bit on us as coaches. We just got to talk through that a little bit more. We'll work on it a little bit in practice. Good thing we don't play them until January, and we can come back. We'll show a little bit better next time.
Yep. Well, Coach, they had Lene Green down there inside. She's tough.
Yeah, she's
I had her for 22, tough. And I don't know how many rebounds she had, but a bunch.
Yeah, she had to have several. She's a good player. We know, I mean, her family's really good. Logan Green was always a tough one in football, basketball, baseball for Clarinda, and then they moved to Shan, and she's good. She's going to get a lot of points.
Yeah.
We just don't have that size, but we're going to work on some things. We'll have a little better game plan for it next time.
There you go. See you Friday night. It's Kemper here Friday
night.
That's
right, Kemper. Big rated Kemper coming to town. Hopefully we got 2 days to prepare for it. We'll be ready.
There you go. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, guys.
Head coach of the Red Oak Tigers, Tristan Johnson, with us. And quick look at some stats here for the Shenandoah Phillies. Chloe Denton, a lot of Phillies in the scoring column tonight. Chloe Denton with 4 points, 1 of 2 from the foul line. Abigail Dumler with 5 points. Sarah Pickens has 2. Callie Bebout has 2. Alexis Chabon with 5. Caroline Rogers has 2 points. Cassidy Stevens with 5 points. Jenna Burdorf wraps up the night with 12. Kylie Fouch with 7. And Lene Green with 22 points and 2 of 3 from the foul line. For the Red Oak Tigers, looks like Olivia Boswell wraps the night with 7 points, 0 of 1 from the foul line. Haley Rydberg has 3. Casey Kells with 2. Merced Ramirez finishes with 8, 0 of 2 from the foul line. Ellison Johnson with 2 points. And Emily Siebenecker has 5 points and 0 of 2 from the foul line. And again, it was Shenandoah over Red Oak, 66-27 in varsity girls play. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll come back, turn the page, and talk about varsity boys play right after this. Aaron West and Matt Davis, varsity boys play upcoming. And Matt, break it down for me here. What do you see when you look at these two teams?
Yeah, here we go. Kind of the opposite of the girls match here in the perspective. It's the Riddle boys coming in here against the Riddle, against the Shenandoah Mustangs. You kind of think the boys from Riddle going to be favored in this one. Mustangs are 0-3, head coach Ryan Spiegel. They've lost to Underwood, Southwest Valley, and Harlan on here. Their highest point total in the game has been 39 this year. Last year, they're 2-20. Red Oak has won the last 7 games in this series. The last Shenandoah win was in February of 2020. They're led by senior Camden Lorimore, 9 points per game. Shoots 45% from 3. Junior Dalton, 8th and 9 points per game. As a team, the Mustangs shoot 31% from the field, 26% from the 3. They've only shot 38 threes. They don't shoot a lot of threes, 40% from the free throw line. They're averaging 35 points per game, like I said. Kind of a low total there, 68 points they give up defensively, 22 turnovers per game. So you look at this and compare that against the Tiger team coming in 1-2, beat Lenox, lost a tough one to Clarinda, played a tough Lewis Central team. Of course, they're led by senior Max DeVries, averaging 22 points per game. That's fourth in the Hawkeye 10, Hunter Gillum, 18 points per game. He's a senior. Cyrus Minson, 5 points, 5 rebounds as well. He's a senior for the Tigers. Tigers are averaging 61 points per game, giving up 70 defensively. Tigers shooting 39% from the field, 21% from the three line, 75% from the free throw line. They're averaging 17 turnovers per game, 19 fouls per game. Way too high of a number, Aaron. That number is going to have to come down. But the Tigers at 11 steals. It's a kind of a fine edge there for the Tigers. They play aggressively, get defensively, but that also a lot of foul. We've seen Hunter Gillen getting foul trouble. We've seen some other players getting foul troubles. But that's kind of where the Tigers are. My guess is the Tigers will do the same thing we saw in the girls' game. I think the Tigers will come out, if not at least initially, they'll be pressing at some point in time. They'll probably go man-to-man defense against this Shenandoah team. One thing I've noticed stat-wise, Aaron, in the first three games, teams are running Max off the three-point line.
Yeah.
Normally, he's right there in the conference leaders in the top two or three. Statistically, in three-point attempts, he's not even in the top five. So that's telling me that the team, the message is out. You want to run Max off the three-point line. And Mac, to Max's credit, he knows that. He's been taking a lot of hard drives to the bucket. Really, teams are making him work hard for his points. Well, let's see. That's probably, I'm sure, Shenandoah's game plan tonight as well, to try to run Max off that three-point line. But the big story, of course, tonight, other than the game, of course, is that Max is 12 points away from becoming the all-time scoring leader in school history. If that happens, they will stop the game, and we'll have a little presentation in that. Yeah. At that time.
So, and that's not a single season. That's
all time
score. 11 ties, 12 breaks.
All time. You know, I had the opportunity to text and communicate with the still current all time scoring leader.
This is a 30-plus year old record, Matt.
Chad Blackman. Yeah, 31 years. He graduated in 1992, and I had a chance to text back and forth to Chad. And I said, Chad, do you know this? He goes, yeah, but I said, he says, I'm down here in the Florida Keys, so he's. You know, Chad is not too nervous or worried about his record getting broke. He's sitting down in some tropical location in the Florida Keys with his family enjoying a game. He did say he'll be watching in on live stream, and he said, you know, hey, he hopes Max breaks it and holds it at least as long as he did. But, you know, I asked Chad, they stopped the game and all that stuff when he's got, he says, I didn't realize I had it until the end of the year. I read it in the Red Oak Express. So a little bit different world here. In terms of that, so Chad wasn't even aware that he had the all-time record until he read it in the paper at the end of the school year.
Well, it should be fun. So when these teams get together, like I said, it's always a lot of fun. Let's just take a quick break, and we'll come back with your keys after this, Matt. Red Oak, Orange Gymnasium, Red Oak and Shenandoah. Varsity girls play. Shenandoah comes up big this evening, 66-27 in varsity girls play. Keys to the game in varsity boys, Matt, or what?
Well, for Shenandoah, take care of the ball. Try to run Red Oak, at least Max, off that three-point line. Run your offense and just play solid defense the best you can. For the Tigers, I think they want to get this game up and down and going. They're going to need to take charges more than reach on these steals. I think they need to help limit the fouls, move the feet more, less hands. I think Red Oak wants to knock down some threes tonight. I think they want to try to get that going. It'll be interesting to see if that happens. But looks like
there you go, Matt.
Unbelievable. We got our student body broadcasting the game. They're a great group of kids. There's a flock of them down there. There's about five of them.
They keep adding to the comments.
They have a lot of commentators.
They have many commentators. I see 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 6 commentators, Matt. 6.
6 of them down
6
there.
Of them cut down there. So
I'm not sure what they're hooked into, but they're hooked into something. So there you go. It's kind of like the Manning cast. You know, there's an alternative. You kind of have a Manning
there you cast go. There.
But this should be a good game, Matt. Rival game. And, you know, Red Oak is, of course, wanting to get in that win column and shake these 2 losses they had. Mustangs are looking for their first victory on the season here, but this stretch of games coming up, you know, for the Tigers, they've had 9. They'll have 9 games before Christmas break, so they'll have arguably the best team at conference coming in Friday night.
Yes, yeah.
Kemper, and then they've got, I think next week they've got Harlan. I think they might have Denison, so they have a really front-loaded schedule, some of the more heavyweight teams in the Hawkeye 10.
I think Tuesday night we have a boys-only East Mills game.
East Mills game, yeah. There you go. Yep. So Coach Schaefer, that'd be good. We'll get the old ball coach Kevin Schaefer in the game. That'll be good to see. But
all right.
But here we are, a Tuesday night, Red Oak Gym, good crowd. Good crowd here from Shenandoah. And
we'll take a quick break, Matt, and come back and look at the lineups after this. Orange Gymnasium. Reserves for the Shenandoah Mustangs here this evening. Juan Cepeda is a senior at 6'2". Seth Zwickel, a senior, 5'11". Logan Twyman is a sophomore, 6 foot. Eli Cameron, a sophomore, 6 foot. Aiden Johnson, sophomore, 6'2". And Cole Graham is the sophomore, 6'1". Those are reserves for the Mustangs. Starters for the Mustangs will be Jade Spangler, a senior, 5'11". Camden Lorimore is a senior, 5'10". Brody Burdorf, a sophomore, 6'6", sophomore. Dalton Nathan, a junior, at 6'2". And Joey O'Rourke is a freshman, 6'1". Those are your starters for the Mustangs this evening. Red Oak Tigers reserves include Carson Roeder, a freshman, 5'6". Ethan Fouts, a sophomore, at 6'2". Mason Fisher is a sophomore, 5'8". Landon Gigstad, a junior, 6'4". Reese Montgomery, a freshman, 6'4". Tyler Beeson is a senior, 6'4". Weston Kaus, a freshman, 5'9". Brandon Hernandez, a senior, 6'1". Caden Foster is a 6-foot senior. Bennett Johnson, a senior, 6'2". Peyton Ekternaw, a senior, 6'4". And Jack Schmedke round out the reserves for the Red Oak Tigers. Starters for the Red Oak Tigers this evening, Hunter Gillen, a senior at 5'8". Brighton Bergeron, a senior, 6'3". You have Cyrus Minson, a senior, listed as 6'5". Max DeVries is a senior, 6'4", and Braden Sifford is a junior, 5'10". Starters for the Red Oak Tigers. Up-tempo game, pushing the ball. What favors the
That's what the Tigers want. Yeah, absolutely.
What do the Mustangs want, Matt?
Yeah, I think the Mustangs just want to play solid basketball. I don't know if they want to get in a track meet with Red Oak, but take care of the ball, play good defense, and try to limit the possessions from the Tigers here.
Got the hype video going now for the Red Oak Tigers.
Yeah. So, but, you know, for the Tigers to get a W tonight would be big to try to get things turned around here a little bit. We always look at Red Oak basketball program, and we see them settle in more in that January because they always play a very, very tough pre-Christmas schedule. And, you know, they come into that second half of the season. Their record doesn't look great, but the really good Tiger teams – hit their stride usually in that late January, February time. Those teams that we've seen that make some moves. And I think this team has that potential. You kind of weather the storm against the bigger loaded teams, and then you start settling. I think the big game for Red Oak this year will be the MAC shootout on a Saturday in Council Bluffs. I think that's coming up here in a week or two. That Underwood team they'll play, that's a team they'll see in the playoffs, and that'll be a measuring stick game right there.
All right. Again, like I said, the introduction set to be made. We're going to step away one last time, and we'll be back with the opening tip after this. Red Oak, introductions being made. Nice crowd of people has made its way here into the gym for the Tigers here.
One player I'm curious and want to watch for the Mustangs is freshman Joey O'Rourke, 6'1 player. He is a tremendous ball player, tremendous talent as a freshman, and really interested to see him play tonight for the Mustangs.
All right.
Tigers going with their usual starting lineup here.
Introductions being made. Cyrus with his introductory flip into the game. And it's just about basketball time. This O'Rourke kid, Joey O'Rourke, a freshman, Matt.
Yeah, he's a tremendous ball player. I've seen him from about a fifth grader playing YMCA ball and coming up, and he is a good one. And this is a kid that this Mustang program can build around. So, and then the Burdorf kid, of course, he's got good height. He's 6'6". He's just a sophomore. So this is a young Mustang team, but there's some talent on there.
These are the kids, when they hit to be seniors, you're going to feel like they've been around forever.
Absolutely. And, you know, and the rural work kids got some growing still to do. So this Shenandoah team, their record's not there, and they may not be the record they want this year, but there's some talent in the pipeline here.
Boy,
but Tigers got some talent, too, down there. Reese Montgomery and Carson Roeder. So both these programs are set up for long term here.
Yeah, they certainly, there's a lot of young talent here that I think they'd be excited about, Matt. Here we go. Burdorf at center circle, Minson at center circle, tapped in. The Tigers come away with it. Gillen to Sifford out on the left side in the corner goes to Berggren.
Mustangs come out in a 2-3.
Deep three from Sifford, no good. Rebound chased down to the corner. It's Minson. It's DeVries. He spins his way into the lane, kicks it to Sifford. Three again off the left side, not there. Rebound brought down by Aiton. Down to the other end quickly. Spangler to the hoop, puts it up. It's blocked.
Berggren with a great block there.
DeVries into the lane, kicks it out to Berggren for three. Not there. Rebound again on the backside by Aiton. Outlet pass goes to Spangler. Out on left side, Spangler with the ball.
Tigers have not shot the ball well from three this year, Aaron. I'd like to see them try to get that cooking tonight if they can.
Burdorf out on the right side. Takes it in toward the lane. It's Spangler. Spangler long two off the right wing. No good. Rebound, Sifford. Quickly up the court to Berggren. Back to Sifford, right side in the corner. It's DeVries for three, in and out, no good. Rebound Lorimer.
Tigers 0 from 4 from the field to start the game.
It's going
to
go out of play. That pass to Spangler was a little out of his reach and goes out of play.
All shots from the Tigers have been three-point shots so far in the game.
Neither team having scored at this point. 6:52 to play in the first.
Tigers really don't have that low post scoring presence, but they have guys that can slash and cut to the rim. Let's see the Tigers try to work something to the rim here.
Bergeron for three off the left wing. Not there. Rebound again, Ethan.
Tigers 0 for 5 to start the game.
Ethan starting off hot on the boards. Spangler, Ethan. Top the key to Lorimer. Lorimer sets the play. He backs out to the center circle. Pressure from Gilliland. Round to the right side. Spangler looking inside. Hits Ethan underneath. And he kicks it out to Burdorf. Almost lost the ball. Burdorf takes it in lane. It's blocked. Coming away with it. Bergeron flips it to Gilliland. And he's going to be whistled for the travel.
I'm not sure Hunter had possession, but a quick whistle there on the travel. So, Shenandoah basketball. It looks like the Tigers are going to go full court press here, Aaron.
Still, neither team having scored.
They're going to put it actually on the side here.
Yeah. Yep, and the inbound pass will come from O'Rourke to Spangler. Back to O'Rourke. He takes it across the center stripe. Foul Minson.
Yeah, just can't have that. Foul out top like that, not necessary.
First foul on Minson, first foul of the ball game, actually.
And we talked about that right up with 19 fouls, average 19 fouls a game. That's a foul you don't need right there.
Lorimer with the ball near the center stripe out in the corner. Now to Spangler. Dumps it down underneath the eighth, and he puts it up. No good. Rebound Minson.
Good job by Cyrus Minson on the rebound there.
Hit Gillen down to the left wing, into the blocks. Kicks it out to Bergeron for three off the right side.
There's one.
Snaps the net with it.
I like the fact that Brighton kept shooting there. It's finally got one to go. We're going to have a travel there on Shenandoah. Sometimes you just got to keep on shooting, Aaron.
Just keep on shooting.
That shooter's mentality, you always think you're going to make the next one, even if you're 0 for 100.
Bergeron will put it into play for Red Oak. 3-0, Red Oak leads now, 5:42 to play in the first. Sifford with the ball. At the top of the key, gets it to Minson. Behind the arc, Bergeron. In the corner, it goes to Sifford. Working it around the perimeter. Bergeron at the top of the key, gets it to DeVries.
O'Rourke, the freshman, on the senior DeVries.
DeVries takes it into the lane, spins, kicks it out to Sifford. There's Minson, little jumper, no good. Rebound tapped to Bergeron. Underneath, Minson puts it up, no good. Rebound brought down by Burdorf.
Yeah,
jump
good,
ball.
Good hands there. The possession will go to Shenandoah, but good job there by Shenandoah internally with defense. Getting arms up. And O'Rourke has some good size to him as a freshman. You know, most freshmen, he's got good size, and he's a tremendous athlete.
O'Rourke takes it across center stripe. He's trapped. Tries to step through it. Stolen by Gillen. Gillen takes it across the center stripe, and then we're going to have a foul on Spangler.
Yeah.
Jade Spangler. That's his first. That's the first team foul on the Mustangs.
Tiger ball under the basket here. They'll inbound it.
DeVries will put it into play. 5 minutes to play in the first. 3-0, Red Oak with the lead. Inbound pass to Bergeron. Now to Minson. Top the key for three. Nope. Rebound, Burdorf.
Tigers 1-for-6 from the field, 1-for-6 from three.
O'Rourke takes it into the lane. Minson gets a hand on it. It goes out of play, and the Mustangs control it.
Yeah.
At the baseline, Lorimer will put it into play. Camden Lorimer. Inbound pass comes to Ethan. He just kind of backs his way in there. No good. Gets the board. Goes
Mustangs,
back up.
Mustangs really owning the glass
yes,
here.
Yes, they are. And Ethan gets the bucket after just effort.
Just grit there by the Mustangs, out gritting the Tigers.
3-2 is the score. Red Oak leads. DeVries getting pressure from O'Rourke. Now to Sifford. Now Minson with the ball. Bergeron baseline. Sifford takes it into the lane, dumps it off underneath, and it goes out of play off the Tigers.
Mustangs really playing good defense here, doing what they need to do. Tigers are going to go press here now.
O'Rourke will put it into play. Full court press from the Tigers. Inbound pass to Spangler. Hits Lorimer in the middle. Down to the other end, it's Burdorf.
Tigers Lucky there, Mustangs had a layup three-point shot from the corner.
Eighth and no good. Rebound pulled down by Minson down the other end. And
Tigers really not in sync offensively right now. Aaron, just a bad pass there. Ooh, almost over and back there.
Lormer just stepped across the center line as he caught that. Out to Bergdorf on the left side.
Good cut there.
Hits O'Rourke, and he was just absolutely wide open underneath.
Mustangs playing well here out on the lead, 4-3.
4-3, Siffer drives in lane, kicks it to DeVries out on the right wing. He takes it inside.
We're going to have a block. The block.
Yeah. Foul is on Ethan. Nope, it's on O'Rourke. He called that on O'Rourke.
Beeson in, Minson out. Tigers were inbound here.
3:33 to play in the first. 4-3. Shenandoah with the lead.
Yeah, O'Rourke's coming out of the game. He's been a good. He's really been handling Max, not allowing the drive, playing good defense on DeVries.
DeVries at the baseline. Inbound pass to Berggren. Beeson.
No.
For three, no good. Rebound pulled down by
Tigers. Are not getting second chance opportunities there. Just settling for jump shots from the 3-point line.
Underneath the Ethan spins his way in there. He's going to be fouled on the play, I believe. Sifford.
Mustangs are the better team the first 5 minutes of this game, Aaron.
Sifford has whistled for his first. And at the line will be Dalton Ethan. He has 2 points in the game. Doing great on the boards. Shots up. It's good. Dalton Ethan, 5-3. Shenandoah with the lead here with 3:20 to play in the first. Dalton Ethan at the line. Second shot's no good. Rebound, Beeson. Beeson with the ball on the right wing. Tyler Beeson. Underneath it goes to Gillen. Back to Beeson.
Tigers got to get a little grittier, Aaron. Bergdorf with a two-shot, two-point. They're going to call it a two.
Oh, they called it two?
Called it two.
Two-pointer from Bergdorf. Down the lane, Spangler for the layup. No good. Rebound bounces out wild. And Gillen comes away with it, takes it to the blocks.
It's going to be a charge.
Charge on Hunter. It's his first. Tied up at five apiece with 2:46 to play in the first.
Yeah, I think the Tigers are just trying to push it too much offensively when it's not there. If it's not there, you pull it back out, and you got to run your offense.
Inbound pass comes from Graham to Lormer. Graham with the ball. Full court press from the Tigers. Graham to Zwickel.
10 seconds.
10 seconds.
Shot clock's at 25, so that's a pretty good indicator. It's 10 seconds.
And the Tigers will have the ball. Tied up at five apiece with 2:35 to play in the first.
And the Red Oak needs to create turnovers off that press there to help their offense.
Gillen with the ball. Pressure from Zwickel. Now to Minson. Behind the arc. Minson with the ball. DeVries, top of the key. Takes it down in lane. Puts up the jumper. It's no good. Rebound pulled down by Graham. Knocked loose. Right underneath. Max gets two.
Tigers go back in that full court press.
Regular leads 7-5. Red Oak with the lead. Graham with the ball. Now to Lormer. Down to the other end. It goes to Ethan. Drives down the sideline. Underneath to Graham, and we're going to have a foul on Berggren.
Yeah, again, reaching there. Looks like Bergdorf's back in, Spangler's back in, and O'Rourke is back in. O'Rourke has been a tough defensive handle on DeVries this first quarter here.
Certainly. And the Mustangs have the ball. The inbound pass will come from Zwickel. Seth Zwickel will put it into play for Shenandoah. Out to O'Rourke. In the corner to Zwickel. O'Rourke out at the top of the key. Over to the left side to Spangler. Drives, kicks it out to Bergdorf. Bergdorf into the left elbow. And again, a foul on Berger.
That's two quick ones on Brighton, and you got to move the feet. You can't move the hands. You got to move your feet. So Tigers in foul trouble. Looks like Gigstead's going to be coming in for the Tigers. And Tigers with five team fouls. So it's two shots now, Aaron. So, you know, I made that pregame. Tigers have to stop fouling.
And at the line will be Bergdorf now. Brody Bergdorf at the line. First opportunity from the line.
So Mustangs will have two shots here on every foul for the rest of the quarter.
shots, no good. A minute 50 to play in the first, 7-5 Red Oak leads.
Shenandoah is not a good free throw shooting team. 44%, I believe, is the team.
Burdorf, second shot, no good. Rebound, Sifford. Sifford takes it back across the center stripe to the top of the key. Out on the right side, Minson for three. It's good.
Nice shot by Cyrus. Stepped into that well, had a good lead pass. He was able to gather himself and had a nice rotation on the shot.
Zwickel with the ball at the top of the key for Shenandoah. Now left to O'Rourke. Takes it down the blocks, kicks it to Burdorf. Burdorf in the lane. Now to Cepeda. He takes it into the hoop, puts it up. No good. Rebound, Minson.
Nice job by Cyrus again, clearing the glass for the Tigers there.
Beeson to Sifford in the corner to Vries. He fakes it, drives the baseline, puts it up. No good. Rebound knocked loose, and O'Rourke comes away with it. O'Rourke takes it end-to-end and fouled by Beeson.
Yeah, O'Rourke's a good ball player. You can see he glided down the court there and came back to the left side and didn't get the bucket, but he had two shots. Tigers need to take some charges. That's one of my key. Stop reaching. Move the feet. Take some charges. Easy for us to say it up here, isn't it?
Shot from O'Rourke is good. Joey O'Rourke. He's a freshman, man.
Yeah, he's going to be a good one.
He's an impressive freshman player. First shot was good. 10-6 is the score. Red Oak leads with a minute 7 to play in the first. O'Rourke at the line. Gets them both. Minute 6 to play in the first. Beeson for three. In and out, no good. There's DeVries with the board and the reverse layup for two.
But an offensive rebound for the Tigers. That might be their first one of the night. Tigers do not press. They drop back now.
12-7, Red Oak leads with 50 seconds to play in the first. Left side to Lormer. Top key to Zwickel. Right side, Spangler looking inside.
Good
dumps
D.
It knocked loose by Minson. Picked up by DeVries, takes it to the end, puts up the jumper off balance and scores two.
Max was 6 points, six away from the school record.
Spangler with the ball, 26 seconds and counting here in the first. Spangler at the center circle, 20 seconds. They can take it all the way down, Matt. Shot clock's not in effect here. 13 seconds, Lormer with the ball. Drives into the lane, puts it up, and scores two. Nice job by Camden Lormer.
Yeah, that's the second hard drive the Mustangs have taken. They're the lead pass.
DeVries takes it to the hoop and scores two. And that's going to do it. Max DeVries with now 8 points, 16-9 at the end of the first. We'll take a break and be back with the second right after this. Back 16-9, Red Oak leads as we head into the second quarter here, Matt. Tigers will have the ball. Inbound pass will come from Beeson, midcourt, far side. What's the discussion here going on?
Oh, I think they're just kind of anticipating a stoppage here somewhere this quarter.
Tigers will have the ball as we come back to action. Down the corner goes to Beeson. DeVries, left wing. Around the arc, now to Sifford. Top of the key, Sifford with the ball, well behind the arc. Beeson takes the three, he's open, it's no good. Rebound, brought down Spangler.
Tigers being limited pretty much to one shot on the offensive end, Aaron.
Out on the left side to Lormer. 7.5 minutes to play in the half. Down inside to Cepeda. Lorimer drives the baseline, blocked by Beeson, but he is fouled.
I'm going to say hit two shots. So
number two on Beeson.
So a foul and two shots for the Mustangs.
Lorimer will go to the line. Camden Lorimer, this is his first opportunity from the line this evening.
But almost all of the Tiger fouls, Aaron, are on reaches defensively, reaching. Have to move the feet, have to stay in front of someone.
Shot from Lorimer is good. First of two. Second shot, Lorimer.
This is how a team can stay in the game at the foul line.
Shot is good. He gets them both. Nice and easy. 16-11 in the corner goes to Beeson. Behind the arc, Beeson with the ball.
Ryan needs to look for the drive a little bit. He's going to have an opportunity to drive here.
Sifford to Beeson, 7-10 to play in the half.
There's a good pass.
It's Minson in the blocks. He puts it up. No good. There's Johnson with the board out to Beeson. He's a wide open for three. No good. Rebound, Ethan. Ethan pushing across the center stripe. Takes it to the hoop. It's blocked. Minson comes away with it. Gets it to Beeson. Now Sifford takes it across center stripe. Top the key. Over to left side to Minson. DeVries. Pressure from O'Rourke. Now to Minson for three. No good. Rebound on the backside. It's Beeson with the ball. Back out top the key to Sifford. 6.5 minutes to play in the half.
Tigers need to swing, cut, move a little bit more.
Beeson for three. No good. Rebound. Johnson kicks it to Sifford.
Second rebound for Bennett Johnson.
Minson for the 10-footer. It's good.
There's some second chance opportunities. Bennett Johnson with two good offensive rebounds so far in the game.
Down underneath. Ethan is there. Loses the handle on it. Kicks it in the corner to Spangler, drives the blocks, puts it up off the glass. It's no good. Rebound, DeVries. Two on one here. DeVries takes it to the hoop off the glass and scores two.
Max 2 points away from the school record.
He has 10, 11 ties. Down underneath.
Tigers are giving up drive to the buckets here. And I know I sound like a broken record, Aaron. I apologize, but it's just a matter of getting in front of people. That's why I said in the keys of the game is to take a charge.
O'Rourke at the line. Shot is no good from O'Rourke.
So we're up with two team fouls now. 5:49 into the second quarter.
O'Rourke at the line. First shot was no good. 20 to 11. Second shot from O'Rourke is good.
So here we go. Sifford with the ball for the Tigers out top. Dribble drive. Kick back out to Bergen. Bergen at top.
5:39 to play in the half. There's DeVries for three.
That's good. It's
good. DeVries with three, and that's the school record.
That's it. It's all-time scoring leader in Red Oak school history. Max DeVries, that's just his name, in school history records for the Road Tigers.
So there's going to be a bit of a presentation here for Max.
Being presented with the basketball by Athletic Director Mark Erickson. He breaks the record of Chad Blackman, who has held it, set it in 1992, and held it for 31 years. Chad is, I know, watching tonight. He's down in the Florida Keys with his family, probably at a nice tropical bar or restaurant, but he was very excited to know Max is going to break his record, and he hopes Max holds it for as long as he did. So tremendous accomplishment here by Max DeVries.
Yes.
And it's good to see.
The all-time scoring leader for the Red Oak Tigers.
And that says something. There's been a tremendous amount of basketball players. You go back to eras of the 50s. Of course, it's a different game in three-point shot, but the Tag Tigrins, the Gary Browers, the Bob Lovejoys, the Denny Blooms, the Bill DeWitts. You know, you go through just through all the different eras. You had the Blackmans, the Tommy Wrights, the Todd Tigrins, all those guys that come through this program. And I'm missing a lot, but he sits atop of them all with the all-time scoring leader for Red Oak.
pretty special honor right there.
And more importantly, the three was a big one for Red Oak. It stretches the lead out over 11 against Shenandoah.
Congratulations to Max. 5:28. Here we go, Matt. Back at it. Over the left side it goes now to Graham. Top of the key to Lorimer. Lorimer takes it to the blocks and puts it up. No good. Rebound is tapped. It goes out of play. Tigers ball.
Bennett Johnson again battling on the boards in there, Aaron. I really like what Bennett Johnson's giving the Tigers.
23-12. Red Oak with the lead now with 5:13 to play in the half. Sifford out to DeVries on the right side, right wing behind the arc. Bergeron, top of the key, left side Sifford. And he goes to Johnson. Out to Sifford. He takes the three off the left wing. Tapped, and it's going to be reeled in finally by Graham to Lorimer.
Tigers staying in this man-to-man defense, Aaron.
Left side to Graham. Down underneath. Ethan puts it up and in for two.
Nice little cut there by Ethan.
You know, he plays hard down there. Gets a lot of boards.
He does. Solid ball player.
Bergeron. Sifford. DeVries open for three from the top of the key, and he snaps the net with that one, too.
Max with 16 points on the night so far.
Down underneath Ethan. Blocked by Johnson. Ethan gets it, just bulls his way in, kicks it out to Burdorf. And we're going to have a foul on DeVries.
Well, that's got the student bodies fired up with Bennett Johnson out there. He's a student body favorite. This play. Of course, we saw Ben on the football field. We thought he did a fabulous job.
He did.
As a center this year. A center was, when you don't – go ahead.
No, I was going to say you never – it was a perfect snap every time.
Yeah, we never mentioned anything about the bad snaps or anything. He just really solidified that center of that line for the Red Tiger football team. And you can see here he's having positive contributions on the court for the Red basketball team.
Spangler around the right side. Dobson underneath again to Ethan. Backing his way, just a lot of pressure, nothing there. Gets it Spangler for three. It's good.
Nice kick out there, but held their post there against Ethan, but he found the guy out top, and that was a good job by the Mustangs to find an open player for a bucket.
Sifford for three.
Braden's got to get back in the game there. His shot's not going. He's got to understand the shot doesn't dictate your gameplay. Play hard, good defense.
Left side to Lorimer, behind the arc, dumps it down underneath. O'Rourke backs his way in there, puts it in for two.
Mustangs are going down low, Aaron. They know that the Red don't have low post presence. They're attacking down low.
DeVries is just feeling it here. Another three by DeVries.
He is on fire. Tigers need to get tougher and grittier down low here. The Mustangs are just going inside.
Burdorf.
With drives and putbacks offensively.
Burdorf to Ethan. Drives down the lane on the blocks, puts it up. It's blocked again by Johnson. DeVries comes away with it for Red Oak. Out to Sifford underneath Johnson, and it rolls around and in for two.
Around and down, and that's going to call a timeout, Aaron. Bennett Johnson has been a spark off the bench.
Yes, he has. Timeout on the court. We'll take it. 31-19 is our score with here in the second quarter, and we'll be back after this.
Just got a text from the former Red Oak Tiger head coach Spencer Plank. He's watching tonight. He's telling everybody he's super proud of Max. So, Coach Spencer Plank, he's up at Buena Vista.
Good evening, Coach.
High school up in Omaha. Not sure if his team has started their season. I'm assuming they have.
Coach Plank, he's a good one, Matt.
Yeah, we really like Spencer's time here. Great coach, great person, and we're happy for him. He's able to get up there, be around his family more in Omaha. So,
great coach. I think maybe even better person.
Absolutely.
31-19 is our score. Red Oak with the lead, 2:54 to play in the half. Here we go. Shenandoah with the ball.
He was an Illinois Illini. He is an Illinois Illini fan, though.
Well, everybody
That's
can't
strange.
Be a Razorback
That's
fan.
Strange.
Lorimer with the three. No good. Rebound to DeVries. DeVries across center stripe, takes it down to the baseline. Out to Sifford. Swinging around the arc. Minson for three.
No, Cyrus.
Cyrus Minson.
Cyrus likes that corner ball. He's very good at getting the pass and just going straight to his shot. Good defense there by the Tigers.
Yep. Underneath Cepeda, grabs it, puts it back up. No good. Rebound DeVries.
Yeah, Mustangs, you're just trying to get that ball down low. You can see they're trying to use their muscle down low.
DeVries takes it to the hoop, puts it up. We have a foul, I believe, on the floor.
Tigers have stretched this out to a 15-point lead as Max has really gotten hot here.
O'Rourke gets whistled for the foul. Is that Roeder coming into the game?
Carson Roeder, freshman for Tigers in the game. Bennett Johnson comes out. Getting a lot of congratulations to teammates. Great effort there by Bennett.
Minson. Beeson looks at the three, out to Sifford, inside through the hands of a couple of Tigers.
And
Roeder takes the three. Oh,
Carson Roeder with his, I think, his first bucket as a varsity player.
Shot rebound. Goes up, rebound Minson, out the pass goes to Roeder.
Roeder just a freshman.
Left side to Sifford, into the lane he goes, kicks it to DeVries.
You know, you look at some of these freshmen out here, O'Rourke and Roeder, picked by DeVries.
Rebound Burdorf, and we're going to have a foul on the...
And here, yeah, that's a foul 75 feet away from the.
And it's on Beeson. I think that's three on him.
Yeah, and that's a fourth team foul.
Maybe that's two on him.
Almost every quarter, Riddle flirts with that five team foul.
You've been talking about that all season, Matt.
It's something that as these games get more meaningful in the second half, they're going to have to control the fouling situation.
On the left side is Zwickel. In the corner goes to Spangler. He skips it across to Lorimer out on the right wing. He takes it to the blocks, dumps it underneath Burdorf. It's blocked from behind by DeVries. Spangler with three. No good. Rebound Zwickel.
Mustangs getting a lot of offensive second chances here.
Spangler,
good block.
Blocked again by DeVries, and he chases it down, gets it to Minson, back to DeVries.
Max really playing tough down low. He's got several blocks already on the night.
Sifford takes it into the lane on the right side, fakes it, takes it, and scores it. Brandon Sifford.
There's a good take. When your shot's not working for you, Aaron, take it to the bucket. That's what Sifford did there.
Underneath, Cepeda puts it up, and Minson's going to be whistled for the foul.
That's going to be the 15th foul, so Riddle for two quarters has gone to the five-foul max limit.
That's three on Cyrus.
So Cyrus with three, Max with two, Sifford with two.
Shot from Cepeda, is that no good?
Tigers up 20. They really just got hot here with their outside shooting in this second quarter, specifically Max.
39-19. Second shot from Cepeda is good. 39-20. Sifford, Beeson to Sifford behind the arc. Back to Beeson, top the key.
And they're playing off the Tigers there. They know the Mustangs who they play off there.
Sifford,
giving a shot.
Beeson for three. Not there.
Rebound
him, Berggren.
And he was fouled.
I think Cepeda maybe. It is. That's his first.
Tigers have not had a lot of second chance opportunities there, but that was a good job there by Brighton. The battle on the board 33 seconds ago. They turned the shot clock off. Tigers can hold if they want to, but knowing the Tigers, they won't. They're kind of a see and shoot.
Just like that, DeVries shots up, no good. It goes out of play. Tigers will keep it.
I'm going to say it stays with Reddit. They're going to confer here. I think they're going to overturn this here. My guess is they're going to overturn it.
Yeah, they're just discussing it.
One's talking the other end. We're going to stay with Riddle ball.
Tigers ball. 26 seconds to play in the half. 39-20 is the score. Red Oak with the lead. Inbound pass to Berggren. Comes around the arc. Sifford. Beeson for three off the left wing. It's good.
Beeson got one to go there. Tyler Beeson got one to go there.
Tyler Beeson.
Good defense there by Roeder.
Picked up by Berggren to Roeder out on the left side.
Good
underneath
look.
To Berggren. He spins, kicks it out to DeVries at the top of the key. 5 seconds, DeVries into the blocks, off the glass, no good. There's Beeson with the board and the putback as time expires. Tyler Beeson picks up a couple more, and it's 44-20 at half. We'll be back after this. Halftime, Red Oak leads 44-20 in varsity boys play. And Max DeVries, if people are just tuning in or just clicking over on our YouTube channel, Max did officially break and now has exceeded. He is the official all-time scoring leader for Red Oak.
Yeah, absolutely broke Chad Blackman's record of 31 years ago with, I think, 1,260-some-odd points. But more importantly for the Tigers, Max got hot in that second quarter, and the Tigers really broke the game open there in that second quarter.
Let me give you some stats for the Mustangs here this evening. Jade Spangler has 3 points, one personal foul. Juan Cepeda with 1 point, 1 of 2 from the foul line. Camden Lormer with 4 points. Camden is 2 of 2 from the foul line. Brody Burdorf, 0 of 2 from the foul line. Dalton Nathan with 5 points and 1 of 2 from the foul line. And Joey O'Rourke, the freshman, 7 points and 3 of 4 from the foul line for O'Rourke. We'll take a break and come back and look at stats for the Red Oak Tigers right after this. Red Oak halftime. Red Oak leads 44-20 in varsity boys play. Looking at stats for the Red Oak Tigers here in the first half, Carson Roeder steps in and knocks down a three, has 3 points in the ballgame. Hunter Gillen with one personal foul in the first half. Brighton Bergeron, 2 personal fouls, 5 points in the ballgame. Cyrus Minson with 3 personal fouls. Cyrus has 8 points here in the first half. Max DeVries went off in that first half, Matt. 19 points for Max. Tyler Beeson with 5 points. Braden Sifford has 2 points, and Bennett Johnson with 2 points.
So the Tigers hit 7 3-pointers in that second quarter.
Yep.
Yeah, they really hit the ball there. I thought the Tigers got some really good – I thought Bennett Johnson was really a spark in there.
Yeah,
yeah. He hit the glass hard offensively, showed some physicality down there for the Tigers. He even got a bucket for them. It's anything he gives you point-wise as a bonus. And then, you know, Brighton Bergeron kept shooting the ball, which I thought was good. You know, and you just kind of have to stay with it, get in the rhythm with it. And Carson Roeder off the bench with some points. So getting some contributions from some other guys. Or Hunter Gillen has not scored in the game. And how many fouls does Hunter have?
Hunter has 1.
So keep an eye on that situation here in the second half. But so, yeah, kind of surprising. It was a tight game in that first quarter for the most part. I thought Shindle kind of actually had played Tigers for the first 4 or 5 minutes of the game. And the Mustangs really, you can just tell what offensively they're not even looking three, Aaron. They're just trying to get it down low and use some muscle down there, and that's the Tigers' vulnerability. The Tigers don't have a big post player, so you know they kind of have to do it by committee down there defensively and getting rebounds too. So, but Tigers are in a little bit of foul trouble here. You know, as you look,
they're going to have to keep an eye on it for sure.
And that's the thing, you know, just it changes the way you play and think and. Fouls are going to happen, but you just don't want to commit the fouls that, you know, and call them silly fouls or unnecessary fouls. What do you want to call them? But fouls 70 feet away from your bucket, or just, you know, reaching for someone. You know, if you're beat defensively and you try to reach, you're going to get called for foul. You got to move your feet, and that's why, you know, I look at it and say it's really about defensive positioning, because almost all the Tiger fouls come on the defensive end.
Yeah. Halftime. Red Oak leads 44-20, 3 minutes remaining in half, and then we'll be back at it here. Earlier this evening, just so you know, in junior varsity girls play in two quarters, it was Red Oak over Shenandoah 19-15. Junior varsity boys play, it was Red Oak over Shenandoah 50-39. In varsity girls play, Shenandoah gets the victory in varsity girls play 66-27. We're at halftime of varsity boys. Red Oak leads 44-20 at halftime. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back after these messages.
Kipley trumpet song.
Here you go. So, Matt, we had someone ask what was the record that DeVries broke. It was the all-time scoring record. Career scoring record. Chad Blackman held that before. 1,265 points was the previous record, 91-92 season. And now Max did break that. He needed 11 to tie, 12 to break, and he has 19 here in the first half. So he has exceeded that and is now the all-time scoring leader for the city, or for the school of Red Oak.
Well, the city of Red Oak.
It could be the city of Red Oak, too, I suppose. Out on the right side, Lormer with the ball as we come back to action here.
Tigers 2-3 zone.
Tap loose by Sifford, picked up by Minson. Sifford takes it to the hoop. Nice move by Braden Sifford.
Right here, Tigers full court press. Stolen.
DeVries hits Sifford. Back to DeVries. He's open for three, but Ethan knocks it loose. Outlet pass goes to Spengler. To the other end, he puts it up and in for two. Jade Spengler.
Tigers came out and showed zone defense there, and that's probably because of their fouling situation.
Spinning into lane is DeVries. He puts it up. No good. Rebound, Burdorf. Outlet pass to Lormer. He loses the handle, takes it to the hoop. Blocked by DeVries. We're going to have a whistle on DeVries.
Thought Max might have gotten that, but they're going to whistle Max, and he's got two. Is that right?
I have him for two.
So one foul on Red Oak here.
Lormer will go to the line.
And it's a shooting foul.
Be two shots for Lormer. 7-12 to play in the third, 46-22. Lormer at the line. Shot's good.
It's hard defensively, mentally, when you give up a steal or the guy is beating you to the bucket that you don't want to try to go block it or whatever.
Yeah.
But if you're beaten on a drive, you're beaten. And
that's where a lot of fouls are committed,
yeah,
because you want that block.
Yeah, but you've already been, quote, defeated by the fact that you couldn't keep the player in front of you. So
Lormer gets the second one. It's 46-24. Sifford takes it to the hoop. No good. Rebound pulled down. Burdorf. And Berggren's going to get whistled for the foul.
feet got tangled up there, but another foul, and that's Bergren's, what, fourth? Third?
That is Bergren's third personal.
But a foul, again, way down court away from the bucket.
O'Rourke will put it into play for the Mustangs into Spangler. Pressure here. And Bergren falls on it. Do we have the timeout or the jump ball? Got the jump ball.
Both coaches were calling timeout at the same time, and Ronnie and Spiegel are laughing about that. They're going to say Shenandoah had the timeout before Red Oak.
And they're going to.
Ronnie says, that's fine. That's okay.
All right. So it's a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. 6:54 to play in the third, 46-24. We're at timeout. And was that was attributed to Shenandoah then?
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes. Okay.
All right.
Grace Davis checking in from.
How's Grace?
She says, congratulations to Max. She's excited because her Missouri Tiger football team is in the Cotton Bowl, going to be playing the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Prediction on that one?
Mizzou. M-I-Z. SEC.
Well, I'm surprised you're going for an SEC team.
Ohio State's quarterback's in the portal, and they're having a lot of kids not going to play.
Inbound pass comes to Lorimer. Lorimer to O'Rourke. And it goes out of play. Tigers ball.
Hunter with good defense there on that trap.
Really quiet first half from Gillen.
Yeah.
Inbound pass comes to Sifford. Across the center stripe, out to Gillen on the left side. Now to DeVries on the left side. He takes it into the lane, puts it up kind of sideways, and it falls in for two.
Max has that uncanny ability to just kind of slither to the hoop, as I call it.
Lorimer takes it down the right side of the lane, kicks it out to Ethan for three. Baseline right, it's no good. Rebound, actually, DeVries loses the handle. Lorimer goes up, shoots it, no good. This time DeVries comes away with it. Now to Sifford.
Tigers, right fortunate. Tigers fortunate to get that rebound.
Bergren at the top of the key goes left to Gillen. He flips it to Minson in the corner for three. Nope. Rebound Spangler. 48-24, 6 minutes to play in the third.
Out of bounds.
Ethan steps on the sideline.
You know, every game,
Aaron,
we see at least one, if not two, of those situations in our gym.
Yep.
On that far
side. And it's typically that far side where there's a lot of open space between the side and the bleachers.
Yep.
Gillen out on the left wing. Skips it all the way across to Bergen for three on the right side. Puts it up, no good. There's Sifford with the board. Gets it again. One more time up. He's fouled this time. Nice job by Braden under there.
Yeah, stayed with it. Didn't get it the first time. Went back up, got fouled, had two shots.
Fouls on Lorimer, I believe it is. That's his first. Sifford will go to the line. First opportunity from the line for Braden. Shot's good.
Braden with 5 points on the night. There's some pretty good looking tennis shoes out there tonight. There's a lot of good colorful designs on
second
both
shot.
Teams.
Second shot's no good. Out top, Minson for three. Cyrus
in the double digits with another three, and we're going to have a timeout.
Timeout
here
on the court. 5:35 to play in the third, 52-24. Red Oak leads, and we'll be back after this. Red Oak with the lead, 52-24.
How many threes Red Oak have on tonight, Aaron?
A bunch.
They had seven, quarter.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They have 9 3-pointers here.
By far their high this season.
Lorimer will be fouled by Sifford.
Again, point of being aggressive, but another foul. These fouls are coming way away from the Shenandoah bucket, so 3 team fouls on Red Oak with 5:32 to go. If it's a closer game, this would be a big issue.
Spangler takes it across center stripe into the lane all the way to the hoop. And we have a foul on the play.
And that's going to be four on Minson, so he'll have to come out of the game, Aaron.
That is on Minson. And Minson's having a good ball game. He has 11 points.
I mean, the Tigers are in big-time foul trouble here. You look at their side of the scoreboard, 3-4, 2-3, and we have, what, at least more than a quarter and a half to go in a game.
Spengler's shot is up. It's good.
It's just a matter of discipline and not reaching, Aaron, and understanding the consequences of what a foul is.
Spengler at the line for Shenandoah. 5:27 to play.
A lot of ball game left here.
Spengler, senior, shot's good. He gets them both. 52-26, 5:25 to play in the third.
Gigstad now in for the Tigers.
Gigstad over to the right side to Berggren. Gillen works his way down the right side, hits Berggren on the move. He kicks it out to Gigstad. Into the lane, underneath to DeVries. DeVries spins his way to the nice move by Max for two.
Quick hard spin there. I'm not sure the Tigers can live with the press for too much longer, Aaron.
Down underneath to Cepeda, DeVries. Cepeda puts it up and in for two. 3 points for Cepeda on the evening. Gillen to Gigstad for three. It's Woo! Good.
Look at Landon
Gigstad.
But
50 down.
Second time the Mustangs have just driven right through Graham. The Tiger press.
Cole Graham with two for the Mustangs. Berggren out on the left side. Drives the baseline, has it to the hoop, and loses a handle on it. It goes out of play. Shenandoah's ball.
Let's see if Coach DeVries takes his press off and maybe put the Tigers in some sort of zone defense here. I think that they're going to be a little bit of half-court zone here, press,
Spengler.
Trap, I mean.
Spengler takes it across center stripe out to Zwickel in the corner. Spengler for three. It's no good. Bounces off the top. O'Rourke goes way up and grabs it. Out to Zwickel. End lane jumper from the left elbow is no good. Rebound Cepeda. Actually, he and DeVries tie up.
But
jump ball.
The penetration there just came off a dribble drive, and I think that's got to be a point of emphasis for Red Oak, Aaron, to keep guys out of the lane on a dribble drive, and that's, you know, sliding left and right and getting low in your defensive stance and coming over to help and taking charges. You live with a defensive charge block call. You'll live with that.
Sifford into the lane, kicks it out to Berggren. There's Gillen. Gigstad for three off the right side. Not there this time. Rebound brought down by Graham. Zwickel. Pressure from Gillen. He knocks it loose. Hunter to DeVries. He takes it to the hoop for the fingertip roll.
Good hustle by Hunter there. Got on the floor, scrap for loose ball.
Quickly down to the other end is O'Rourke. He takes it right to the hoop and scores two. The bucket's going to count.
Yeah, Shenandoah's not having a problem breaking the press. They're slicing right through it.
That foul was on Gigstad? I believe so.
Yep, one, first one. Five team fouls now on Red Oak, Aaron. So rest of this quarter for last 3:32, every foul Red Oak commits will be a two-shot foul for Shenandoah. Shenandoah has one foul this quarter.
That's significant, Matt. Shot from O'Rourke is up and no good. Rebound Red Oak quickly to the other end. Beeson out to Sifford, top the key. Sifford pressure from Lorimer. Out of DeVries. O'Rourke is right there on DeVries. He takes it to the hoop. Again, fingertip roll from DeVries.
Max slicing and dicing.
Max has 27. Inside to Spade at the baseline. There's Graham from the foul line. No good. Rebound chased down by
Gigstad.
Nice job by Landon.
Good minutes here from Landon.
Sifford. Into the lane, dumps it to Johnson. He loses the handle on it. It goes out of play.
Right idea. Had a good idea there. He had a good drive trying to drop it off for Bennett. Just deflected away there out of bounds. Be Shenandoah basketball. And the Tigers are backing off the press now.
Inbound pass will come to Lorimer. Lorimer will take it right to left across the center stripe. 2:51 to play in the third. 61-32. Red Oak with the lead. Varsity boys play. Over to the right side to O'Rourke. He skips it all the way across to Lorimer. Lorimer drives the baseline. Kicks it to Cepeda in the lane. He puts it up off the glass. There's O'Rourke with the board up off the glass. No good. Cepeda and the Mustangs getting lots of opportunities.
Well, when the shot goes up, you got to get your guy you're guarding and get it into him and move him out of there with your body.
Gigstad whistled for his second.
And Zaval is just a big kid, and Tigers were not able to do that, and he just stayed in there and didn't get the basket, but he's going to get a free throw, and he makes the first one.
Cepeda gets the first.
So Minson comes in now with four fouls. Gigstad will go out. Good minutes there from Landon Gigstad off the bench for the Tigers.
I like to see that. That's good. Shot from Cepeda. He gets them both.
Nice shot there. So 2:30 to go here in the third quarter.
Gillen with the ball. Goes right. Hands it off to DeVries. Max takes it to the hoop. Puts it up. And no good. Rebound. Zwickel for Shenandoah. Pressure from the Tigers here. Now to Graham. O'Rourke across the timeline. Top of the key. Down the right side of the lane. O'Rourke loses the handle. Out of play. Tigers ball.
O'Rourke with 9 points. He's going to be a ball player, Aaron.
Yeah.
He already is a ball player.
He is a ball player.
Max with a three. No.
Rebound. Beeson. Little six-foot jumper from Beeson is no good. Cepeda taps it out top to Gillen. He'll take the three, and it's no good. Rebound. Zwickel for Shenandoah. And he and Max tie up. Mustangs ball.
In comes
Berdorf.
Berdorf. Out goes Zavala. Did I pronounce that correct?
Cepeda.
Cepeda. I'm sorry. Cepeda. I could not read. I saw the Z. I didn't see the rest of it.
Out on the right side to Graham. Drives to the baseline. Partially blocked by Beeson, I believe, and then gets it and puts it back and in for two. Nice way to just stay with it by Cole Graham. Minson, left wing, now to Beeson. Top key to Gillen, a minute 22 to play in the third. Gillen puts it up, no good. Rebound to Graham.
Graham doing a good job on the glass for the Mustangs.
Doing a nice job. Mustangs overall have done well on the glass.
I think they have, yeah. They've really battled well. And they're doing what they want to do offensively. They're not a three-point shooting team, but they're being effective by working low, trying to get some second-chance opportunities. And Ethan has played well for the Mustangs,
yes,
too,
he
as
has.
Well.
Yep. Little substitutions taking place here, Coach Spiegel.
Bennett Johnson in for the Tigers. Had some good minutes in the first half.
Gillen to DeVries out on the right side. Now to Sifford. Gillen doing a little weave out top. Down to the baseline to Johnson. Now to DeVries. 59 seconds and counting in the third. DeVries takes it to the hoop. Got a foul on the play. I think it's on O'Rourke.
You get two shots. So it's only the second team foul on Shenandoah, but it'll be a shooting. Max is in the process of shooting, so he'll get two shots.
You know, interestingly enough, this is Max's first opportunity from the line.
Yeah. But, you know, we had talked coming in the game how the teams in the conference are running Max off that three-point line. I thought tonight he might have an opportunity for some threes, and that's the way it has gone. It's been more of a typical Max game where he's been able to get some shots from the three, getting some drives to the bucket.
Max gets them both.
29 points. I think
that's correct. 53 seconds remaining. 63-36 is the score. Red Oak with the lead. Out on the right side to Ethan. Behind the arc. Ethan with the ball. Right side. O'Rourke to Lorimer. 39 seconds. O'Rourke on the right wing. Takes it into the lane. Nothing there. Ethan behind the arc. Left side. Down underneath the Graham. Spins. Puts it up right in front of the bucket and scores two. Cole Graham. 22 seconds and counting. Third, Gillen for three. Not there. Rebound Johnson. Back to Gillen. He drives to the baseline. It's blocked. Partially tipped, I should say. And it goes out of play. Shenandoah's ball. Nope, it's Red Oak's ball.
Yep. Bennett Johnson like Ellison Johnson. Very good on the offensive and defensive glass.
And 12 seconds and counting. Red Oak with the ball. Gillen with the ball. Top of the key. 8 seconds out to Sifford. He drives into the lane. Max DeVries for three. Good. Max caps it off in the third.
32 points.
32 points on the night for Max so
far.
Could
he set the single game scoring record the same night he sets the all-time scoring record? It's not out of the realm of possibility.
66-38. Red Oak with the lead. We'll be back with the fourth quarter right after this. 38 is our score. Red Oak with the lead as we head into the fourth quarter. Tigers will have the ball midcourt far side, and Bergeron will put it into play for Red Oak. Here we go. Back to action. Inbound pass comes to Sifford. Sifford walks it across the center stripe, round to the right side, right wing. Sifford with the ball. Out to Bergeron. Kind of a high pass. There's DeVries. Deep three from DeVries. No good. Rebound Gillen. Underneath the Minson. We have a foul on the floor.
Tigers up here handily in the fourth quarter. Keep the Tigers here. Play a clean quarter here. Foul-wise, I think, would be important for the Tigers.
Fouls on Lorimer. Gillen takes it to the hoop. It goes out of play. Mustangs ball.
Yeah, Hunter, just untypical. Some nights it's just not your night. You know, certainly not from a lack of effort.
Yeah. Spengler with the ball. Walks it across the center stripe. Comes right to Lorimer. Drives the baseline to Ethan off the glass. No good. Rebound tapped around. Ethan grabs it. Spinning his way in there. Kicks it to Spengler. Top the key for three. No good. Rebound Ethan again. Ethan and gets two. Ethan does a really nice job.
Yeah, Tigers it. Just not getting it done on the defensive glass.
Gillen. Into the lane, kicks it out to DeVries for three on the right side. Not there. Rebound, Spengler. Now to Lorimer. Skips it across. Ooh. Sifford keeps it in
play.
Oh,
nice play by Sifford.
And Bergeron to Minson.
Nice play there by
the Tigers overall. That was nice.
Nice play there by Sifford to keep it in bounds. And then Bergeron found Minson. Another steal by Sifford.
Sifford. To good. Bergeron for the layup for two.
Nicely done. Sifford with the steal and really led his teammate Bergeron well for the bucket. There's 7 points for Brighton on the night.
70-40 is the score. Red Oak leads with 6.5 minutes to play in the ballgame. Out to Lorimer for three off the left side. It's not there. And Ethan goes up with it.
Tigers need to rebound, get boxing, get bodies in there, Aaron. You can just tell they're just –
Minson finally grabs the board.
Cyrus has been battling hard.
Gillen for three. In and out. Bergeron falls, gets the rebound, and stripped. Bergeron will go to the line, I believe.
When you don't have a big team size-wise, it takes a committee of guys to rebound. Sifford's been getting down there some rebounds, but you've got to put all hands on deck defensively, and that's an area the Tigers are really going to have to work on this year to improve.
Brighton Bergeron at the line. Shots up. It's no good. Substitutions taking place here. Bergeron at the line.
Brighton's game. He's gotten confident, I think, more as the season is going on, Aaron. He seems to be hunting for his shot a little bit more.
Gets the second one. Brighton has 8 points in the ball game here.
I think that's his season high so far.
Inbound pass to O'Rourke.
Minson certainly is at his season high with 13.
Yes, he has. Out to Burdorf. Cameron with the ball inside to Ethan. There's Burdorf out to Cameron, right side. That's Eli Cameron. Burdorf into the left elbow, kicks it to O'Rourke. He drives the baseline, puts it up, and draws the foul. He'll go to line for two.
That is only the first team foul here in the quarter on the Tigers.
Fouls on Bennett Johnson. It's his first. It's going to send Joey O'Rourke to the line. O'Rourke is 3 of 5. This one bounces through. It's good for O'Rourke. That's his first point of the fourth quarter. He has 7-9. That's number 10 that he just scored. This one's up. No good. Rebound. Ethan does it. I don't know how many boards he's had.
Yeah.
But this time Minson grabs it.
Graham and him both have been very effective on the glass.
Yeah, Gillen with the ball. 5:23 to play in the ball game. DeVries in and out. Rebound Ethan. Now Cameron with the ball, right side. Down to the baseline. O'Rourke, he drives. Nice little move to the bucket, and O'Rourke picks up a couple.
You just got to take that baseline away. Aaron Tigers did not give that baseline up, and O'Rourke took it. He has 12 points now.
Gillen into the line. Minson for three, not there. And foul.
I think the ball went over the top, so he'll be up. Minson comes out, Beeson in.
Tigers have gone and gone cold here in this last few minutes.
You know, this is a Tiger team that, you know, I think that Clarinda game was an example of how this Tiger team needs to play in that Clarinda game. Here tonight, they're really hunting the three-point shots.
O'Rourke takes it down the left side, fouled by Gilliland.
And the Tigers are just giving up drives to the bucket here. The last four possessions, the Mustangs have had nothing but drives to the bucket. And got to stay in front.
Gilliland picks up his second personal foul. 4:41 to play in the ballgame. 71-43 is our score. O'Rourke will put it into play for Shenandoah. All the way out to Burdorf near the center stripe. Burdorf to Cameron. Eli Cameron with the ball. Double team. Out to Burdorf, out of play. Tigers ball.
One thing I think that kind of can lure you to sleep a little bit is you tend to think that steals and blocks are indicators of defense. And they are in one hand. But, you know, the type of shot percentage your other team is getting and where those shots are coming from on the floor are also an indicator. And Shenandoah has had almost all their shots here, at least in the second half, right within that lane. And that's from dribble penetrations or drives to the bucket or second-chance rebound opportunities.
Beeson drives to the baseline, kicks it out. He's going to the top of the key. DeVries grabs it, spins his way into the lane, fakes it, kicks it out to Beeson for three. No good.
Good follow there by Beeson. Ooh, Carson Roeder trying to dive for it. Goes into the stands, but he's okay. 4:06 to go here in the game. Sifford out.
Sifford comes out of the ball game. Burdorf will put it into play. Now coming into the ball game is Aiden Johnson taking a seat. Aiden Johnson, first time we've seen him this evening. 71-43 is our score. Red Oak with the lead.
Work now at the point for the Mustangs.
Down underneath is tapped by Gigstead. Pulled down by Johnson. Stripped loose. It's Graham. Off the glass and two for Cole Graham. Roeder, left side, Roeder with the ball. He calls the play, sets the play. Roeder at the top of the key. Goes right to Gigstad, underneath to DeVries. Max puts it up. It's blocked by O'Rourke. Still on scrapping for it, coming away with it. Then will be Johnson. Johnson with the ball. To O'Rourke across the center stripe out on the left side. Burdorf for three. It's no good. Rebound Johnson to Beeson.
Nice job by Bennett Johnson.
3:15 to play in the ballgame. Beeson's open for three. Now to Johnson. Little fadeaway blocked.
You know, I don't find it too much of a reach to say playing the offensive line will help a little bit underneath that hoop rebounding.
Yeah, I think you're
exactly
right.
They're used to pushing bodies around and clearing space and that sort of stuff. And Bennett's one of the football players that's on the team.
Yeah.
He's brought a little bit of football mentality to that front line with the Tigers.
Substitutions taking place here.
Reese Montgomery, a freshman. This is the Tigers have two freshmen in the game now. Montgomery and Roeder.
Yep, bringing the ball across the timeline. Twyman, right side to Graham.
O'Rourke and
Johnson.
O'Rourke and Montgomery have had quite a few battles in
Twyman.
Junior high basketball.
Foul on Gigstead. That's number three on Landon, I believe. It is 2:51 to play. Landon picks up his third.
So with one more foul, and here comes Pickenson size.
Speaking of linemen.
Yeah. But one more foul by Red Oak. Red Oak will have achieved a 5-foul limit in each quarter, Aaron.
Not exactly sure that's what you want, Matt.
No.
Burdorf takes it down to the baseline, blocked by Montgomery.
And there it is.
Is that on? That's on Montgomery. Reese Montgomery.
So I'm not good at math, but 5 times 4 is, what, 20? So at least 20. I think the Tigers came in, I said, averaging 22 fouls per game, is that what it said?
Yep.
Or 19 fouls per game, excuse me.
19.
They've exceeded that tonight.
Shot from Burdorf is good. Brody Burdorf. You know, Matt, we're seeing a lot of freshmen play. I mean, these two teams.
Yeah, I mean, there's a there's both these programs are going to have talented players over the next several years.
Second shot, no good. Rebound, Montgomery.
Obviously, tonight it's been the Max DeVries show, and he's by far the best player on the court. But
Roeder.
There's Montgomery for Red Oak.
Three. Oh, no good. Rebound pulled down by Johnson. Johnson to Twyman. Twyman takes it across the center stop. Burdorf will take the three off the left side. It's not there. Rebound Gigstad to Fisher. Fisher across the center stripe. Down to the right side. Tries to. It does. It gets it to Montgomery for two. Reese Montgomery picks up a couple.
Sophomore and a freshman. They're the quarterback with the pass to Montgomery.
Down underneath the Burdorf. 2:09 to play. Burdorf spins. Puts it up. No good. Rebound. Out of play. Tigers ball. 73-46. With 2:05 to play in the ball game, Red Oak with the lead.
Checking in now is number 35 for Red Oak. Who do you have?
Caden Foster.
Caden Foster in
Caden
for
Foster.
The Tigers.
He's a senior.
So Coach DeVries has emptied the bench here.
Roeder with the ball. Goes left to Montgomery. Out of Fisher. All this behind the arc. There's Roeder for three. No good. Rebound. Out of play, off the Tigers. Inbound pass comes to Twyman. Twyman across the center stripe. Center circle sets the play. And underneath it goes to Graham, but it's knocked out of play. Nice job by Montgomery Real to create that. A minute 39 to play in the ball game. Inbound pass to Roeder. Quickly to the other end to Fisher. He takes it to the hoop. Goes underneath to Foster. Then to Montgomery, who drives to the hoop. Puts it up. No good. Fingertip roll. Brought down by Graham. Graham to Twyman. Ball's going to be picked up by Cameron. Three-pointer off the hands of Twyman. No good. Rebound Montgomery. Reese Montgomery with the ball. Into the lane, Fisher. Here's Montgomery.
Good ball movement here.
Hey, they're moving the ball well, Matt.
Yeah, they're running the offense very well.
1 minute to play. There's Montgomery. Kicks it over to Ekternov. It's going to go out of play.
Peyton thought that was a loose ball on the ground.
He was going to recover the fumble.
Peyton is one of the also student body faves out here.
He came into the studio a while back and I just had a really enjoyable visit with Peyton one morning.
Good kid. Anytime the football players get on the court, the student body just think that's the best thing.
Fisher to Roeder behind the arc. 46 seconds remaining in the ball
game. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second.
And the Tigers don't get it off.
Ran the offense so well, they just kept on running it. So the Tigers will move, what, to 2-2 with the victory tonight?
I don't think that's the way that's supposed to work, Matt.
No?
No. Over the right side it goes to Graham. Underneath it's tapped loose. Montgomery pulls it down. 27 seconds. Montgomery to Fisher. Back to Montgomery. Ekternov.
Ekternov, shoot.
Takes a shot. Gets whistled for the travel.
Peyton didn't know what to do there. The crowd was asking for the three-point shot. He obliged, but didn't go down. He traveled.
Out on the right side it goes to Twyman. Graham, top key to Burdorf. 11 seconds remaining. Burdorf around to the right side, right elbow, 7 seconds. Twyman with the ball. Drives to the blocks. Puts it up. No good. That's going to do it. 73-46 is the final. 73-46, Red Oak with the victory. Quick break, and we will be back after this. Red Oak, and we are joined now head coach of the Red Oak Tigers, Ronnie DeVries, with us. Coach DeVries, kind of a festive night, a fun night for your Tigers. Tell me about your team and their performance here.
Oh, I thought they played good. They played hard. In the beginning, we didn't execute the best. It was kind of a filling out period. They were in another triangle and two on us, which we should be getting used to it by now, but we're not. More things to work on, but once we kind of got our footing and kind of got our feet under us, we kind of took off and ran away with it. So that was good.
Of course, Coach, you're looking at this from two perspectives. You're the head coach, but also that's your son out there. Tell me about the pride you have in your son tonight.
Well, it's, I'm actually extremely impressed with him for what he goes through. We were talking, Brian and I were talking the other day, his third game as a freshman is kind of when he had a good game, and ever since then he's been boxing one, triangled and two'd, doubled when he touches, and for him to go through that night after night and get beat on, knocked down, and I mean, just to do it, I really don't know what to say. I'm proud, I'm impressed, I'm everything. And
well, as you should be.
I'm happy for him.
Yeah, absolutely. But you, like Max said, Matt said, you do see it from two perspectives, as coach and as dad. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And but a fun night.
Fun night. We had a lot of other kids step up.
Cyrus Minson, I thought played a great game.
Yeah, Cyrus, I think it was his career high for varsity games. Tyler Beeson knocked down some good shots.
Great. I had Cyrus for 13.
Yep.
So
Sifford, he played extremely fast.
Bennett
hard.
Johnson.
Bennett came in. They all played extremely well. Hunter got hurt early there in the first. I hope it's not bad. We're not sure what it is quite yet.
The foul situation, the one thing that kind of – a lot of fouls, but, tonight not such a big deal with that when you win by 25-30.
It's one of them games where they can't call them all. Most part, I thought it was fair. I'm just happy. Yeah. I'm extremely happy. Fun night. I'm glad it happened at home. And, ready to get another one.
Well, here's the all-time scoring leader for Red Oak, Max DeVries. Your thoughts on being the all-time scoring leader for Red Oak High School?
It's crazy, honestly. Like, I think about how many good players have gone through this program, and just it hasn't quite sunk in yet. But I know we're gonna go to stadium, have a good time, come back home, and it's gonna settle in like around when I go to bed, and it's just gonna be. It's just a crazy moment for me.
Well, I heard from Chad Blackman. I told you he's watching, I think, down in the Florida Keys tonight, and he tells you congratulations. So there you are. He held the record for 31 years. Think you'll hold it for 31 years?
I hope not. I hope someone comes through here and just rocks it and takes it immediately.
Good answer.
32 points, Max, is what I had you for tonight. That first quarter, Coach DeVries alluded to, was a little bit of a slow start.
Yeah.
But then you got rolling. You had 10 points on the board. Then comes the three at the top of the key. Did you know it was going down?
I wanted to test the waters a little bit for what I could make happen. And I caught that handoff, and they jumped out like I was going to drive. So I just pulled it back and screw it.
Yeah.
Just thought, might as well.
All right. Let it fly, right? Well, congratulations, Max. It's been a lot of fun to watch, and there's a lot of basketball season yet to go. So
you got a wrap to do in the morning. You gonna do it?
Yeah, I'll do the wrap.
All right, you got a wrap.
Hey, wait, no, we have Kemper Friday night, right?
Yep, we have Kemper Friday night.
Yeah, let's go have fun tonight, and we'll worry about that tomorrow,
we'll
I suppose.
About that tomorrow.
Very good. Thank you both.
Yep.
Max DeVries and Coach Ronnie DeVries with us after that ball game. So, congratulations. A lot of fun. Matt, thoughts on that?
Yeah, just a great night to be a Red Oak Tiger. To see someone do something historic like that and share it with his teammates. And like Ronnie said, a lot of great contributions from other Tigers tonight. Cyrus Minson with his season high, Bennett Johnson off the bench, Carson Roeder knocked down a shot, Landon Gigstead got on the scoring sheet. So good effort by the Tigers tonight, and they'll have a tough one Friday night. Maybe the best team in the conference coming into Red Oak Gym. Friday.
Let me give you some – enjoy this one tonight, like I said. Let me give you some stats here for the Red Oak Tigers. And actually, we're going to start with the Shenandoah Mustangs. Jade Spangler is 7 points, 2 of 2 from the foul line. Juan Cepeda has 5 points, 3 of 4 from the foul line. Camden Lormer with 6 points, 4 of 4 from the foul line. Brody Burdorf has 1 point, was 1 of 4 from the foul line. Dalton Nathan finishes with 7 and 1 of 2 from the foul line. Joey O'Rourke, 12 points in the ballgame, 4 of 6 from the foul line for O'Rourke. Cole Graham with 8 points for the Mustangs. For the Red Oak Tigers, it looks like Carson Roeder finishes with 3. Brighton Berggren turns in 8 tonight, 1 of 2 from the foul line for Berggren. Minson, a high point for the year for Minson with 13 points for Cyrus. Also, Landon Gigstad with 3 points. Reese Montgomery chips in 2 points for the Tigers. Max DeVries wraps up with 32 points, 2 of 2 from the foul line, and sets the all-time scoring record here, or breaks the all-time scoring record, rather, here this evening. Tyler Beeson with 5 points for the Tigers. Braden Sifford finishes with 5 points, 1 of 2 from the foul line. And Bennett Johnson has 2 points